PSG for its recent gains and his comments, vowing Turkey will do whatever is necessary and accusing the YPG of secretly being in league with the Islamic State despite having taken territory directly from the Islamic State. Turkey has long opposed the growth of the YPG and complained bitterly about U.S. and Russian support for them against the Islamic State. Turkey appears to believe a larger YPG territory will add to secessionist sentiment in southeastern Turkey, where the Turkish military is carrying out a war against Kurdish separatists. You can support FPP Radio by shopping online. Whether you're looking for precious metals, bitcoins, or books, you'll find that and more at shop.fppradio.com. Every purchase you make from one of my affiliates, like Namecheap and Amazon, at shop.fppradio.com helps fund FPP Radio. Or you can shop directly from FPP with Bitcoin in the Bitcoin store. That's shop.fppradio.com. UPI reports congressional leaders and White House officials are reportedly nearing an agreement on a two-year budget as well as lifting the debt ceiling. Officials have until November 3rd to raise the debt limit before the U.S. Treasury says it will run out of money. The deadline to fund the federal government is December 3rd. Also under consideration are measures to fund highway and infrastructure construction, which must be renewed by the end of the week, and renew the Export-Import Bank for another year after it lapsed over the summer. Under current negotiations for the budget deal, defense and non-defense spending would get a boost of $50 billion in 2016 and $30 billion in 2017. Additionally, there would be a cap imposed on premium increases for Medicare Part B beneficiaries. Assuming the budget deal can be voted on this week in the House, it will pass only with overwhelming Democratic support. House Republicans are unlikely to support a compromise agreement. A deal would eliminate the issue of a government shutdown.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports under new rules to be considered by transportation officials in Sacramento, loud, smelly people could be asked to leave buses and light rail trains. The proposals come as Sacramento enjoys a downtown building boom that will eventually add a high-end basketball arena and a soccer stadium, amenities that officials hope will draw patrons to the area by light rail, bus, or train. A spokeswoman for the Sacramento Regional Transit District said, "If we can make it more attractive or make it more enjoyable to use the light rail or bus, then people are more apt to use it." Under the proposed ordinance, passengers will no longer be allowed to get on a bus or train unless they are covered, quote, above and below the waist and also wearing shoes. They will be banned from emitting a noxious odor unless the smell is related to a disability or a medical condition. Passengers will not be allowed to play sound equipment that is audible to other passengers and will be banned from sleeping on a train that has reached the end of its line. Those who refuse to comply could be kicked off the bus or train. But advocates for disadvantaged Sacramentans said the regulations were a swipe at homeless people who have a right to ride buses and trains. Pam Haney, advocacy coordinator for Wellsprings Women's Center in Sacramento, told the Sacramento Bee newspaper that she doubts anyone would be kicked off the bus for wearing too much high-end perfume. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Japan grants suffrage to female robots, and a hypochondriac maple tree is always convinced it has Asian longhorn beetles. The following two statements are true. The previous statement is false, and this is the Onion Week in Review. This week, Americans nationwide were stunned to hear horrific allegations on Wall Street revealing that numerous junior bankers have been forced to survive on a mere $6,800 per week. The findings, which implicate numerous high-profile financial institutions such as Bank of America, Morgan Stanley, and Citibank, suggest that hundreds of first-year bankers are constantly deprived of basic necessities, including penthouse apartments overlooking Central Park and regular company-financed vacations to the French Riviera.
Many of these bankers are 23 or 24 years old and don't even have access to an expense account of over $50,000 a year. Not only that, but some of them are making as little as 20 times minimum wage. I mean, this is truly disgraceful.
This is the Onion News Network. This is Free Talk Live, and of course, you can join us here. We'll give you our toll-free numbers and the Skype in moments with you in the studio tonight. You've got Ian.
And Conan.
And Mark.
And you can join us online. Just drop on by freetalklive.com. Brand new website for 2015. Last time we redesigned was 5 years ago. It looks sharp and getting a lot of compliments. So if you haven't dropped by, please do. Go to freetalklive.com. If you find something wrong, you can definitely let me know. And we'll do our best to get it fixed. But it's looking pretty good. freetalklive.com. Tonight, Conan, it's been all over social media, the video of a student in South Carolina being essentially body slammed while still sitting at the desk.
Yeah, this has been up for a couple of days now, and I've seen it shared in multiple locations, and I just never even looked at it, you know, because I'm not surprised. I mean,
I don't look anymore either, generally.
I just saw it for the first time about 3 or 4 minutes ago, and not surprised at all. This girl, whatever she did, you know, she ended up getting dragged out of her chair and body slammed and dragged back and forth throughout the classroom while the other students sat and just watched like it was something that happened to
them. What are they supposed to do, though? What are the other students supposed to do?
You know, especially considering that the officers, you know, probably got 100 pounds in each one of those kids. I mean, yeah, there's nothing.
There was a video of the guy bench pressing like 610 pounds. Yeah, that was I saw a quick video of it. I didn't really count the plates or anything like that. But I'm like, oh yeah, that guy's strong.
So I'm with you, Conan. I see so many of these things cross my social media feeds that I've seen so many cop videos of cops shooting dogs, cops killing innocent people. I've seen so much of it. It's hard to keep watching it all.
You definitely have to turn it off because, I mean, that's all we get. I mean, I'm buddies with a couple of some city people, and, you know, I got people back home, and I'm aware of what they're going to be sharing, you know, kitty cats and, you know, mm-hmm. good stuff. But I don't know, libertarians, anarchists, voluntarists, they're always seeming to be sharing this stuff because they want people out there to know it's actually taking place.
Yeah, it's important that you know this. And in this case, this guy, you know, the kind of desks I'm talking about in school, for those that aren't familiar, I know that when I was growing up, there was like two different types. There was the kind of desk that had a separate chair,
mm-hmm. yeah.
and the chair, you know, you'd scoot under your desk or whatever. These are the ones with the chair that's attached to the desktop itself.
Yeah, so you're almost locked inside of it. So,
yeah.
So it gets flipped over. You're still locked inside of it like a yeah.
You got about 90 degrees that you can slide out.
There's
on.
There's one way out, one
right.
way in.
Right.
And he just grabs her and flips her inside while she's still in this desk.
It looks like a car wreck. I can imagine the way her, you know, head snaps against the floor and stuff.
God, I didn't even notice her head snapping against the floor.
Well, if you get thrown that way.
I haven't played it multiple times, but it looked horrible enough on the first run through. Conan, you've got the story here from CNN. Do you want to share any details?
I could go right through the article or
sure.
I can just...
go for it.
Okay, here we go. Breaking news posted 5:55. This was on Tuesday, October.
That's today.
All right. Well, Richland County Sheriff Leon Lott told reporters Tuesday that the student seen arrested in a South Carolina classroom bears some responsibility. Her violent arrest was captured in a video that went viral. If she had not disrupted the school and disrupted that class, we would not be standing here today.
Well, okay, so he's claiming that she has some responsibility, not all responsibility, mm-hmm. and I think that's a good point. Now, let me ask you this, Ian. If a student, say you're running a class, and a student becomes verbally disruptive, and, you know, what would you do in that circumstance?
Let's see. What would I do as a teacher in the class?
Verbally disruptive.
I'd probably ask them to quiet down.
Yeah, and then they don't do that. I think that's a given here.
Yeah. Well, I mean, that's why you do have security to handle unruly people.
Ultimately, right. Security is going to have to bodily, if somebody refuses to get, continues to be verbally unruly mm-hmm. and refuses to get out of their chair, you're going to have to bodily remove them.
But I don't think you need to slam the person in a body slam move. That doesn't seem necessary to me.
It looks bad.
Look, if you're a professional security agent, you're trained, or you should be trained, in how to manipulate people physically, meaning that, you know, there's all kinds of martial arts, for instance, where
a quick arm up behind the back and the scale is going to get right up out of her chair. Right.
That's what I was going to say. All you need is to get a hold of one of their limbs and
a thumb lock, you know, get a hold of the pinky.
And if for whatever reason the security person, let's say you don't have
even the old time school mom would have grabbed her by her ear, right?
Yeah. I mean, let's say you don't have a bruiser of a security guy, you know, let's say it's just an average guy. You know, one guy might be able to handle a big girl, but if you had two of them or a teacher who was willing to assist, again, you know, if you've got enough adults, you could have four regular teachers who aren't even security come in, grab one limb, and take the girl out of there, right? Without having to flip the desk with the girl still in the desk, possibly causing some serious trauma.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I think she...
This is going to be a lawsuit against the school.
Yeah, she fractured her hand and had some facial lacerations and whatnot. And there was, I believe, one of the principals was in there. I mean, there were more adults. So, yeah, according to this guy, we wouldn't be standing here if she hadn't been so disruptive. So it started with her, and it ended with my officer. What I'm going to deal with is what my deputy did, he said. The sheriff spoke about the existence of another video that purportedly shows the student resisting.
Purportedly.
It shows that the officer, as he put his hands on her, her punching him, Lott told CNN, adding that the student's behavior doesn't justify what happened after.
All right.
I haven't seen that video yet. I'm waiting for that one to come out.
Okay, so here you do have the sheriff saying that that it sounds like he agrees that his officer was out of line in this case, which is a pretty rare thing. I mean, a lot of cases of police abuse, the cops back their boy to the end, and usually it comes out okay for him because they back him, and then they usually come out with some sort of press release.
I think
that says,
things are changing.
Yeah,
he
was protecting himself, or so.
You think so huh, say. Mark? What's the evidence for that?
It's mounting over and over. Things are going to change.
Well, I'd love to see the evidence that is mounting. I have yet to see it. This maybe
when we first started talking about these issues, like 10 years ago, mm-hmm. Ian, it was always, you know, nobody agreed with you, none at all. We were the voice crying in the wilderness, as it were, and it's not that way anymore.
Yeah, but
now there's all kinds of statistics. They weren't even counting the number of people that were killed by police a year in the United States.
No, I get what you're saying. I understand there's a rising tide against police abuse. I agree with that. But to say that the police themselves are somehow going to police themselves better, I don't see any evidence for that.
I wouldn't go that far. I'd say
I thought that's what you were saying.
Currently,
I apologize.
What they're feeling like is they're feeling like a vilified underclass.
Yes, and they should, because they've dug themselves into this hole.
They're not vilified underclass. They have more political power than you or I am individually.
You're right. Realistically, they're not. But if they're starting to feel that way, I hope they do. I hope they continue to feel that way.
It's not a particularly productive way to feel. To feel like a, if you feel like a vilified underclass, you're going to, you know, see the injustice all around you. Mm. Not the injustice that you're committing, but the injustice that is being committed to you. It's a terrible place to be coming from. So you don't learn in that position because things are happening to you. It's you're reactionary in your thinking.
Well, I mean, I certainly think that people should give the police constructive criticism. Meaning that if the police are doing something that is, you know, morally wrong, like, let's say, arresting people for peaceful people for things that don't actually harm others, like having a plant or a chemical or an alcoholic beverage.
Well, here's what happens when people actually stand up. You got Quentin Tarantino, who's actually come out, and he's, you know, he's rallying with all the folks against police brutality.
Mm-hmm.
And what's their solution? They're going to boycott Quentin Tarantino movies.
The police are.
Yeah, they're going at it as hard as they can.
Wow.
So I mean, but you got someone on the left who has a, you know, it's a recognizable name, and he's actually coming out. I think that's what it's going to take. It's going to take more big names,
more celebrities,
more big names to come out and say, hey, look, these, you know, you guys aren't. This isn't Andy Griffith. You guys are, you know, Nazis.
You know, before you know it, I mean, Tarantino, maybe he's going to be working on a movie script that'll be about corrupt cops.
That could be about the thin blue line. And about
supposedly, every time you bring up Nazis, you lose the argument.
I know.
I've heard that. I don't know.
Who brought up the Nazis? Tarantino?
It's some theory where as soon as you escalate the conversation to Nazism, you immediately lose the conversation and people stop listening. You just lost. So not a good debate tactic.
Yep, I forget what that is called at the moment, but I know I looked it up recently when you forgot what it was called.
It wasn't Gresham's Law.
It wasn't Gresham's, right. We know, Godwin, that Godwin's was what it was, law. Godwin's Law. The Free Talk Live, join us.
Ooh, get the stinky dog away from me.
Petey stopped eating. All his hair fell out.
Mounds and mounds of fur. Our hairballs have hairballs.
Bad breath and bad gas.
Chew himself raw.
Sticky, gooey, smelly.
She scratched incessantly.
At least $5,000 in vet bills.
And all it took was one container of Dynavite.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
The omega-3 fatty acids.
Flaxseed, zinc, alfalfa.
The digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
Adding Dynavite to their diet has every single dog in my kennel looking better than they have ever looked.
The shedding has stopped and the itching has stopped.
Tons of energy. No more bad smell.
She has gotten this puppy look. Her coat has sheen.
Everything we tried failed except the Dynavite.
My vet was completely blown away.
Dynavite's the bomb.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com.
My name is Bill Bonner, and I'm the president of the largest private news and research network in the world. And I paid for this airtime because I have an important message to the American people. There's a change coming that the government isn't telling you about. This change has deep implications for life in America, from where you shop to the doctors you visit and the family you want to protect. Look, I've made predictions like this before. Thing is, I was right then, too. A few years ago, I warned that housing prices would collapse. They did. Before that, I warned that dot-com companies would crash. They did. Those who listened had a chance to save themselves. But this has nothing to do with the stock market. This will affect us all.
You can watch the video for free right now by going to disappearingwealth.com. Again, that's disappearingwealth.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
The new fourth edition of Healing Our World, The Compassion of Libertarianism will take your understanding of liberty to a deeper level and has over 1,300 updated references, new cartoons, and a foreword by Dr. Ron Paul. With discounts for multiple book purchases, the new Healing Our World is a great gift this Christmas for the liberals, pragmatists, environmentalists, and Christians in your life who think libertarianism is cold-hearted. Get yours today at healing.freetalklive.com and use promo code FTL for a $5 discount.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Of course, you can join us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We also have Skype. Skype username for you is lrn.fm. Just send a contact request along via Skype, and we'll get you added to our contact list So you can easily call us from that point forward. You might like to comment on the situation in Richland County with a man named Ben Fields, sheriff's deputy, who supposedly was forced, he claims, to get physical with a teenage student at the high school who would not apparently get up from her chair. And there is a longer version of this, because one of the reasons why I didn't want to watch this video initially was because I had heard that it was only a clip of the actual throwdown where he picks this girl up in this chair and flips her backwards. I described it as a body slam the first time, but that was after I'd only seen it once. It sort of felt like that. He definitely slams her, but he doesn't like pick her up above his head or anything. He grabs her and like shoves her backwards to where the whole desk flips over, flips over itself basically. And there's a longer version now because, you know, when you don't have context, it's hard to take a position on something. And the claim is that she was somehow attacking him in advance, like hitting him. Mm-hmm. Conan, you'd mentioned that to us. So we'll continue with the analysis of this here in moments. And also apparently this cop who was Ben Fields.
Well, one thing about getting good video is that oftentimes – whatever you wanted to video is gone before you get your camera out.
That's true.
This is one of the arguments against sort of concealed carry of firearms is that whatever the crime is, it's already occurred before you have a chance to pull out. And it was the same with the camera. It's going to take you it's a very skilled and vigilant person that's ready more in quicker than 10
and
seconds.
And if the actors are just having a debate, they're just having a conversation – there's no reason to videotape it until it actually accumulates to where someone's getting thrown around right on their desk, and then it's YouTube worthy.
So we'll get into more analysis of the video here, and you're welcome to share your thoughts. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. You can go and save at Amazon. Save 20%, 25%, how about 40%? I've done all of those things. I've saved 30% as well. Mark, you've saved 45% at Amazon. The way you do it is you have to have Bitcoin. And you have to go through saveatpurse.com. That's saveatpurse.com. Once again, that gives you huge discounts. You get to select your discount. So if you want 40%, choose 40%. And then you just have to be patient because it takes longer to fulfill a 40% order than it does a 20% order. 20%, you'll probably get it fulfilled in a couple hours. It's awesome. Go and try for yourself. Purse.freetalklive.com. Or actually, that's the old URL. That still works. You can go to saveatpurse.com. Saveatpurse.com. It's Ian Conan and Mark here in the studio with you tonight. Ben Fields, Deputy Ben Fields. Apparently, he's had a bit of a history. According to Huffington Post, the same officer who has basically slammed a teenage girl completely unnecessarily in a South Carolina high school has also had a bit of a history here. The story from HuffingtonPost.com, at least I have the story here, I think, in a moment. Yeah, he's been sued twice before. The South Carolina resource officer, and by the way, as a school resource officer, you should be better with dealing with teenagers.
Yeah, I know. How does he even get a job as a resource officer? So, I mean,
how does he keep it?
So, yeah, the question is, these other lawsuits. What was he a beat cop? You know, what was he doing then? Or was he also a resource cop officer? And they were all against students. But yeah, I mean, you would think he's got 100 pounds on these kids. You'd think he'd be able to manage himself a little better.
He's, definitely not a small man. The officer apparently had been sued twice before. In 2007, a motorist accused him of using excessive force when he was a rookie cop in Columbia, South Carolina. And in a second case, expected to go to trial in January, Fields is one of 10 defendants answering a student's charge that he was wrongly expelled from the same high school where Monday's altercation took place. Carlos Edward Martin sued Fields, another deputy, and Richland County Sheriff Leon Lott in 2007, claiming that Fields attacked him after pulling him over. Martin said Fields slammed him to the ground. Yeah, that's believable. Kicked him, handcuffed him, and sprayed him with mace. Fields supposedly snapped when Martin called him dude, according to the New York Daily News.
Dude.
However, the jury ruled in favor of the cop. The description of that encounter sounds similarly violent to Fields' recent film takedown of the Spring Valley High School student who authorities say disobeyed orders to leave class. The video shows the officer flipping the student's desk, and by the way, she's black and he's not, And he pulls her up from the seat, Fields can be seen dragging her to the front of the classroom and arresting her for disturbing school, according to the Richland County Sheriff's Department. Now, disturbing school is a new charge for me. I can't say I've ever heard of disturbing school before, so I took the time to go ahead and pull up the South Carolina statutes. Find out exactly what that means.
What does disturbing school mean? It seems obvious from the title.
Is it the same as disturbing prison?
Yeah, well, I mean, there's a lot of similarities between schools and prisons, but that's a whole other conversation. In this case, it's Section 1617.320 of the South Carolina Code. This is from the SC Statehouse Gov website. So let's see here. I thought I had it in front of me. I apologize. Terrible at show prep here tonight. I went down a little bit too far. I will pull it up for you. But remember, when we were in school, if you disturbed the school, you'd get what was called a referral. And the referral would mean you'd have to go to the principal's office. And at that point, they would come up with some sort of punishment for you.
Yeah, usually they would say, hey, you disturbing the class, go see the principal.
Right.
And then they would page ahead so the principal knew someone was on their way. And you'd go have a talk with them. And I got paddled one time when I was in first grade, I believe.
Yeah, they still had paddlings in elementary school for me, too, in Florida. But eventually, you know, they didn't use paddlings anymore, and they came up with other punishments like, you know,
after school detention.
Saturday school was another one for people that got in trouble more often. I went to that once, and then, you know, sometimes maybe like picking up garbage around the campus or something like that. But now there's disturbing school. I apologize. It's Section 1617.420. It shall be unlawful. Number one, for any person willfully or unnecessarily. A, to interfere with or disturb in any way or in any place the students or teachers of any school or college in this state. Wow. I mean, there's more to it, but that alone is a huge catch-all charge. I mean, it sounds like the equivalent of like a disorderly conduct charge, except it's specific to schools. Disturb in any way. So if I'm outside of a school and I've got an offensive, let's say, sign outside of the school. You know, like the protesters from the Westboro Baptist Church. They have some offensive signs, but they have a right to have those things. If someone's disturbed in the school, they're looking out the window during a test, and they're upset at the fact that someone's out there protesting, is that enough reason for someone to be arrested for this?
You're disturbing school, Ian.
Part B, to loiter about such school or college premises. Or Part C, to act in an obnoxious manner thereon.
You're out of here. You are going to the principal's office. No,
they don't even do that anymore. They call the cops. That's why they got this guy in their school. I mean, he has the ability to arrest the person on site and drag him out to his car in handcuffs, or he'll probably call his buddies in and they'll...
The question is, how many people have been charged with this? It's Free Talk Live.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey system. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting goberkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists, get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug-out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
Hey guys, Mark Claire here, LionsOfLiberty.com, where we strive to advance the ideas of liberty daily. We bring you The Morning Roar! That's right, every Monday to Friday, we'll have a brand new edition of The Morning Roar, where we provide a roundup of some news stories that you may not find in the mainstream media, or even in your typical social media news feed. We find stories that relate to the ideas of liberty, and provide you with our liberty perspective on them. Every Monday, we have our longest-running feature, Mondays with Murray, named after the great libertarian Murray Rothbard, where we'll examine an article or an excerpt from his works and help convey his view, along with our little spin as well. We wrap it all up every Friday with Felony Friday, where our own John Odermatt goes out and takes a look at some sort of felony. There's felonies committed every day, you know, whether it's a felony committed by the police, a politician, or even an average citizen. You can find all of this and so much more over at lionsofliberty.com, advancing the ideas of liberty daily.
This year, Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Tuesday, gold is even at $1,164 per ounce, and silver is even at $15.91 per ounce. Bitcoin is currently trading at $293. Roberts & Roberts Brokerage, a trusted name in precious metals since 1977. When you're serious about precious metals, give us a call at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.co.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm. Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. You may join us right here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We're talking about the video from a South Carolina school in Richland County with Sheriff's Deputy Ben Fields, who attacks a young lady who doesn't want to get out of her chair. And the claim, and I don't know, I haven't seen it myself, but Conan, you said you've seen someone say that the allegation was the young lady attacked the cop, hit him in some way prior to him flipping her back in the chair, dragging the chair forward, dragging on her, ultimately succeeding in pulling her separate from this chair. It's one of those kind of chairs that it's attached to the desk, so you can only get out from one direction. And then ultimately, you know, handcuffing her and her arresting her. I didn't see that part.
I didn't see the hitting.
No. Well, did you watch the longer video?
No, I don't think I did.
Okay, well, the video that this has been shared the most is the short 15-second version.
I think the one I saw was longer than that, but maybe it was just slightly longer. Go ahead.
Well, there is a video that's probably like a minute and a half in length where he kind of saunters over to her. I'll play it here in a moment. But there's the short one where it's just the actual attack of the officer. And I agree with you. In the video where he saunters over and then has a few words with her before he actually proceeds to attack her, it doesn't appear as though she does anything but sit in her chair.
Right. I don't see her touching him at all. But oftentimes in circumstances like this, you'll hear people exaggerating what is a hit, mm-hmm. right? Like hit means one thing when you say it, but you know, if it's a touch, is that a hit? Like it's a hit, only slower.
Maybe she hit him with her hair as she turned her head when he
flipped
her. I
felt the wind. That could have been a bullet.
All right, so we'll get into more about this. Also, you can join us here, and you can bring up anything. On Skype, we have Modern Drummer on the line in Wisconsin. Are you there?
Yeah.
Hey, you're on the air.
You bet. In the movie Demolition Man, if you remember, in the movie they would issue a citation if someone said something that was a naughty word or something like that.
Oh yeah, I remember you get a little
a demerit slip kind of thing.
Something that costs you money.
Yeah. And not exactly the same thing, but there's talk in Silicon Valley about using shaming pop-up ads if someone's about to post something that is deemed offensive or something like that, where they would say, hey, do you realize you're being racist right now? Are you sure you want to post this?
So the idea would be that this would be software running on certain servers hosting things like forums or Facebook or something like that, where if the certain words or phrases are detected, it would then pop up.
Yes, I presume that's correct. I didn't read the original article from Wired Magazine. I read it off of InfoWars.
It just sounds like a different kind of filter. I mean, they've had filters on forums for years. There are forums, lots of forum software has bad words filters. So you can go in and you can have, you know, a whole list of bad words that aren't allowed in the forum. Let's say you're going to have children in there or something like that. Whatever the reason, maybe the forum owners don't want naughty language on their forum, whatever.
But wait till these software companies are required by law to include these in their software, like Facebook, Twitter. Like, you guys can't run your business unless you've got these filters on, because we can't have, you know, the white supremacy crap or this or people talking about Black Lives Matter. I mean, it's all.
I mean, you really think that's going to happen, Conan?
I know that there are policymakers out there right now who want stuff
want
like
that.
This.
They may want that, but there is that pesky free speech thing.
And there's also, this is technology we're talking about, and it's going so fast they can't keep up.
Yeah, I don't know, Modern Drummer. Are you really concerned about this?
No, I think it's stupid because if
I'm with you,
because if I were going to call someone not a racist name, I don't do that. But if I were going to use a four-letter word, a shaming pop-up message wouldn't even slow me down.
Yeah.
So I don't know what that would even do.
I gotcha. Hey, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. It's just going to upset the person who's trying to post, I guess, and then they'll probably curse again.
No, they'll
just
at
the website.
Ad block will create a new shame block software, so you can go ahead and download it.
I want to know what racist.
Yeah, there's always going to be a workaround.
Who gets to decide what racist is? I mean, obviously, if you're tossing out the N-word or variety other racial epithets, it seems like you might be somewhere in the gray area. Certainly. Mm-hmm. However, if you, I mean, you know, there's some. For instance, speaking out against Israel is often called anti-Semitic. People will just immediately, it's the first thing they say if somebody says, you know what, I don't think I like the Israel's policy towards the Palestinian in the West Bank. It seems like they're moving in and, putting settlers in there. And, you know, like you say that, you're an anti-Semite, in order to shut the conversation down.
Yeah, I don't like the American government, but that doesn't mean I dislike Americans. I think most of them are nice people.
But you don't stand up for the pledge either, and you just
that's I don't like the government.
That's where you went across the line, and people just can't have that. Who is that guy over there?
Well, they may not like it, but hey, you got to be true to yourself. So our toll free number is 855-450-FREE. You know, if you're online, ProXPN isn't going to protect you from a shaming pop up, but ProXPN will protect your identity. And they will protect your location. It's a virtual private network. It encrypts your online data. That's the service they provide, encryption, meaning that your own internet service provider won't know where you're going and what you're doing anymore. You can actually use the web anonymously, if you like, with ProXPN. And unlike other VPNs, ProXPN doesn't keep any logs of your activities whatsoever. So go to proxpn.com. You can use code FTL50. And you'll get 50% off the regular monthly price for the lifetime of an annual account. It can be cheaper per month than a good cup of coffee. And ProXPN has more servers than ever before, giving you greater speed and security. Plus, they've integrated Nonkly.com to mask your emails if you get the premium account. So go to ProXPN.com and use code FTL50 and take back the privacy that is your right.
You know, I'm looking at the Keene High School naughty list, things you can and cannot do. I can't find any disturbing school. They've got their whole list of things they don't want done, You know, like,
well, I mean, do they include murder on that list?
No, it goes all the way up to paraphernalia and being under the influence. and none of them are call the cops. They're all first-time offenses, administration, and health office intervention. And in none of it goes to call the cops and have your butt arrested.
Yeah, and to be fair, at least in New Hampshire that I've heard, I haven't seen any kind of vicious attacks by police on students in New Hampshire. So.
Well, they've brought the dogs in and had their little search last year.
Did they?
They went all down the corridors and checked
That's
all the lockers.
Creepy police state nonsense. I mean, I'm no fan of that, but I have not heard anything about a student being body slammed or anything like that in New Hampshire. But South Carolina Deputy Ben Fields has attacked a student. The news is everywhere. It's been all over social media, at least in my world here. And the young lady has been charged with what is called disturbing schools. And Section 1 of disturbing schools in the statutes says that it shall be disturbing. It'll be unlawful for any person to willfully or unnecessarily, which is interesting because that would include someone who's not doing it willfully, right? If it's willfully or unnecessarily, that means that if you intended to cause a disruption, that's disturbing schools. But let's just say you, have Tourette's syndrome or something like that, and you are making a bunch of noise in class and you won't stop doing it. Well, that's unnecessary, right?
Well,
or is it necessary?
What about disagreeing with the teacher? So, for instance, if you, this happens all the time. Students disagree with teachers. Sometimes they're right. Sometimes they're wrong. But this willfully, you wouldn't be willfully disrupting class if you disagreed with the teacher. You're participating in class. However,
right. But they might consider it an unnecessary.
You might be considered unnecessary because your opinion doesn't matter when you're in government school. And frankly, from what I can tell, most schools.
You make a good point there.
So that's what I would think that, to some extent you'd be dealing with there.
We'll share more of
opinions. We can't have them.
We'll share more of this. Plus, we'll give you a kind of a play-by-play of what happens in the longer video that you may or may not yet have seen. This is Free Talk Live. If you want to comment on the continued problem of police abuse, our number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. This is Free Talk Live.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
You can control your health care with Liberty Health Share.
Liberty Health Share is like-minded people coming together to share medical costs, which saves money.
You don't even have to pay for procedures that violate your conscience.
Because we all share the same values.
Join the movement of people who share in medical costs and change the way you pay for your health care forever.
Go to libertyhealthshare.org to find out more.
Liberty Health Share.
Together, we're changing health care for good. libertyhealthshare.org.
So you've got to take a state construction license exam or certification. Can't decide on what books or what chapters to study? Discover right now how you can eliminate unnecessary books and wasted study time. At contractorexam.com, our study materials zero in on state-required test topics in an effective, multiple-choice format. So whether you're a plumber, electrician, general contractor, or other construction-related trade, contractorexam.com will help get you prepared. Visit us at www.contractorexam.com today.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Keenevention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenevention.info. Keenevention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, illegal Uber driver Christopher David, Neocash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Sylvia, rated an A+ by the NHLA, the Seditious Sirens, the Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, tech guru Brian Sovereign, Cop blocker J.P. Freeman, new mover Dr. Taryn Lupo, longtime political activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Halloween costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at Keenevention.info. Visit Keenevention.info for more speaker announcements, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's Keenevention.info.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
My name is Jacob Hornberger. I'm president of the Future of Freedom Foundation, which Congressman Ron Paul awarded for having an outstanding freedom website. Write us at fff@fff.org, and we'll send you a free 3-month subscription to our monthly journal of libertarian essays and our booklet, Economic Liberty in the Constitution, which George Mason University economics professor Walter Williams praised in a recent column. That's fff@fff.org.
Help get LRN.fm into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. You can join us right here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you in studio tonight, it's Ian.
And Conan.
And Mark.
Mark, tell me what the AMP program is.
The AMP program is your opportunity to support Free Talk Live. Free Talk Live is unlike other radio programs out there because we don't fit into that left-right paradigm. We're not telling you that going out and voting for Democrats or going out and voting for Republicans is really a solution. What Free Talk Live believes is a solution is really a paradigm change. It's an evolution in thought where we begin to think about, instead of how can we make a law to solve this problem, is how can we as individuals, as free peoples, solve a problem? And that's just not getting put out there on the radio enough. If you want to hear that message out on to getting into more ears over time, well, the best thing to do is to join the AMP program. It's $5 a month, doesn't cost much, and we give you some perks, among them being the really great AMP group on Facebook where you can participate in decisions that we make on Free Talk Live, among other things. Lots of other discussions going on in there, but you kind of become a chairman of the board of Free Talk Live. It's amp.freetalklive.com.
The Free Talk Live amplifier has got first crack at the brand new Free Talk Live website as well. So you kind of get the first look and first peek into the stuff going on behind the scenes.
And they got to give their advice.
That's right. And a lot of it was heated and heated quickly. So you can check out the new site at freetalklive.com and amp the show at amp.freetalklive.com. We've been discussing Officer Ben Fields and the attack that happened, fairly recently. I'm not sure when exactly this went down, but it's been all over social media in the last 24 or so hours, and there are multiple videos of the Spring Valley officer attacking a student who I don't know if she's been identified yet. Have you, either of you heard about her identity?
I don't recall her name.
At this point?
Her friend, Jenny, the one who was actually taping the incident, she was arrested shortly after. Let me get her actual name.
Now, here's a video from Reginald Seabrooks. I'm not going to play the audio of this video, but I actually have a much longer video because there's two short videos. There are at least three different angles. There are two short videos and then one that's like more than a minute long. I'm going to play through the minute long one. We can actually get some audio off of that to hear what was being said in there. But there's another one by Reginald Seabrooks on his YouTube channel, which is crystal clear. It's like HD quality. It's real close up. The only bad part is
Reginald got a new phone for his birthday.
A lot of kids have jobs and they might actually pay for their own phone.
Yeah, right, Ian. But they don't have jobs.
Well, anyway.
They all have cell phones, though.
He's got a nice phone. And unfortunately, he filmed it vertically. So it's one of those videos.
Well, it just happened to me this weekend.
You film something vertically?
Yeah, I know the feeling. And
amateur.
When you watch videos, sometimes it makes sense. Like, it used to be that it made no sense at all. And I would
it
give
never
you...
makes sense. Almost never makes sense.
Well, what if you're say, videoing a guy dancing right in front of you? So mm-hmm. it's going to be a long shot instead of a wide shot.
There is, like I said, almost never makes sense. Anyway, in the close-up video, you can really see the attack crystal clear. I'm going to put that on our Twitter and our Facebook here in a little bit. That way you can take a close look at this. The video that we're going to play here, the minute-long one, is from across the classroom. So you don't get to see the attack portion as well, but it's the only one that actually has the preface and the aftermath. The others are just a clip of the cop flipping the girl violently backwards while she's still in the desk. So the desk itself goes flipping backwards with her. Luckily, she didn't, like, I don't know. It doesn't
crack her head open.
She is lucky she didn't crack her head open. Yeah. So I'm going to play the audio here. I'll stop it before the S word is uttered because that does come up here relatively quickly. And so he saunters on over as though he has not yet had any words with her. Kind of stands around. He talks to another student. Camera ducks down. All right, here we go.
You don't know me? Okay, you're done with me or you're going to make you?
That was it. That was it. She says, I was fair with you last year, right? She says, I don't know you. He says, you don't know me? And then, you know, you heard the rest
of
it.
He says, come with me. I'm going to make you.
Yeah.
And then he strolls right behind her and then...
And grabs her.
Yeah.
Like, he doesn't really give her a chance to think about going with him.
Yeah, you'd think that there would be a certain period of time that it would take sort of one who's feels that they've been treated unfairly up to this point. And I'm not saying she's, you know, been treated justly or unjustly by her teacher. I don't know what the problem is. However, when you're feeling that sort of, you know, that feeling that comes along with having been treated unfairly to your mind,
you can dig your heels in a little bit.
Yeah, a little bit. I mean, it should, like, you know, somebody who works with young people, and I'm not saying even adults don't have show this behavior, but this shows that somebody who has very little patience working with the public. And, you know, maybe if you don't have any patience working with the public, you shouldn't be a police officer.
I treated you fairly last year, right? He says.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I don't know
other
you.
Black girls in the school, pal.
Okay, you're
going to
come with me or you're going to make you?
Okay, so he says, are you going to come with me or am I going to make you at about 39 seconds in this video? And we'll tell you when, well, you can listen when the actual attack starts. So here we go. One, two, come on. I'll get you up. Then grabs her and throws her backwards. I mean, he doesn't even give any indication that he's going to be violent with her.
Right.
Hey, come on. I'll get you up. And then, wham! Straight back.
How'd you like a little body slam?
I mean, look.
How'd you like to be thrown bodily to the floor?
I've had, you know, up here in New Hampshire, I've had multiple interactions with police. And when they want you to do something, they'll give you warnings first. Like, hey, you're in the wrong area here. You need to leave or else you're going to be arrested for disorderly conduct. And they'll give you a moment to consider their threat. And give you the chance to leave the area. I think because they'd prefer not to do the paperwork or whatever. Like, you know, give them the chance to leave.
Sounds now, reasonable.
Maybe they don't have an obligation to do that, but they have done it on multiple occasions. I remember specifically, I was at a DUI checkpoint. I got out of the passenger side of the car because I'm just the passenger. Shouldn't I be able to exit a stopped vehicle? So I got out. I just wanted to take a little walk with my video camera and sort of see the checkpoint from that angle. And these state police officers started to zero in on me, and one of them was shouting at me that I needed to get back in the car. And I protested. I said, well, I'm just coming out here for a walk. What's the problem with that? He says, if you don't get back into that car, we're going to arrest you for disorderly conduct. And at that point, I decided I'm not in the mood for an arrest tonight, so I'll get back in the car. But the whole way, I protested getting back into the car.
You were disturbing the system, Ian. They had a setup. Everyone's sitting orderly in a line, you know, and they're all showing their IDs. Right. And this,
you
and
can
this,
walk down the road.
And this Nimrod gets out of his car and starts, what we going to ask us questions next? I mean, what's going on? You're videotaping us?
You can walk down the road. You can drive down the road, but you can't drive down the road, then walk down the road.
Yeah. Well, remember, I wasn't driving. I was in the passenger seat. So, I mean, it would have been a bad thing if I was actually driving and abandoned the vehicle. I could see that would be a problem. But anyway, you know, the equivalent of if that were my situation, if what happened in South Carolina were my situation where I got out of the car, the equivalent would be like, here, let me help you back in. Bam! Slam my head off the car. I mean, this is crazy. And then it keeps going. So let me play some more of this audio for you. He's grabbed her. He's thrown her to the front. Give me your hands. Give me your hands. Give me your hands. Grunting. Okay, so he's having a tough time, apparently, with this girl.
Yeah, I mentioned this before. The most amazing thing to me is that everyone in this class that's seen in this video, they're all sitting calmly in their chairs with their hands in their laps practically. And she gets thrown out of her chair. She's on the ground. She does a, you know, she bounces off the ground. No one jumps up. No one is surprised by this. It's like they're used to seeing this on a regular basis.
Well, I want to talk further about that, the way people are reacting here and, you know, what could have been done differently. And I think we can expound on that coming up here in the second hour of the show. If you want to join the discussion on this, the toll-free number, and I'll post the videos here on our Facebook and Twitter here shortly, which you can access through news.freetalklive.com.
I'm stunned by this video, really.
Maybe they didn't want to get charged with disturbing schools. Maybe it's well known that you can be charged with disturbing schools out of line.
Maybe this girl is regularly disturbing the schools, and this has happened before on a lower, smaller level.
Well, the young man who filmed the close-up version of this, Reginald, at least it was uploaded to his YouTube channel. His description of this says, the officer in this is a cool dude. He's not racist. Girl was asked to put her phone away, but told teacher no. An administrator was called and asked her to come to his office. She told him no. Then he called the resource officer. When he got there, he asked her nicely to get up. Over and over, he did nothing wrong, he says. They asked her to get up, but she wanted to show off. To some, it looks bad, but she wanted to prove that she was bad. That's what he had to say about it.
I buy it. I think that's exactly what happened. Now, whether this officer, you know, was, you know, whether he went above and beyond what he should have done.
He definitely went ridiculous with the level of force involved here. 855-450-FREE. That's our toll-free number. This is Free Talk Live. Currency is too important a thing to be left in the hands of government bureaucrats, especially when billions of dollars can be created with the swipe of a pen. Overstock.com supports the cryptocurrency movement because it returns the power of an inflation-proof form of money to the people, where it belongs. Did you know that you can use Bitcoin to pay for anything Overstock.com sells while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more? If you support freedom and the cryptocurrency movement, you should support Overstock.com.
Are your kids spending too much time online? Are they gaming instead of doing homework? Are they on Facebook instead of sleeping? Turn their internet access on or off when you want for free at WebCurfew.com. 100% web-based interface means nothing to download, install, or configure. WebCurfew is free and controls any device using your home network without slowing down your internet. Block all adult web content with a click of a button. Don't let the internet raise your kids. Take back control of how and when your home internet is used for free. Visit WebCurfew.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, October 27th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.88 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,166 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $292. Antiwar.com reports Kurdish forces for the People's Protection Units, YPG, and the Free Syrian Army forces who were fighting alongside them reported they came repeatedly under fire from Turkish soldiers across the border into Tel Abyan, a town the Kurds recently seized from the Islamic State and absorbed into the Kobani Canton. According to the forces on the ground, they repeatedly came under brief machine gun fire from the Turkish side of the border, but did not return fire on the Turkish soldiers. Turkey has not directly addressed this report, but did hint at their involvement. Turkish President Erdogan blasted the YPG for its recent gains in his comments, vowing Turkey will do whatever is necessary and accusing the YPG of secretly being in league with the Islamic State, despite having taken territory directly from the Islamic State. Turkey has long opposed the growth of the YPG and complained bitterly about U.S. and Russian support for them against the Islamic State. Turkey appears to believe a larger YPG territory will add to secessionist sentiment in southeastern Turkey, where the Turkish military is carrying out a war against Kurdish separatists. You can support FPP Radio by shopping online. Whether you're looking for precious metals, bitcoins, or books, you'll find that and more at shop.fppradio.com. Every purchase you make from one of my affiliates, like Namecheap and Amazon, at shop.fppradio.com helps fund FPP Radio. Or you can shop directly from FPP with Bitcoin in the Bitcoin store. That's shop.fppradio.com. UPI reports congressional leaders and White House officials are reportedly nearing an agreement on a two-year budget as well as lifting the debt ceiling. Officials have until November 3rd to raise the debt limit before the U.S. Treasury says it will run out of money. The deadline to fund the federal government is December 3rd. Also under consideration are measures to fund highway and infrastructure construction, which must be renewed by the end of the week, and renew the Export-Import Bank for another year after it lapsed over the summer. Under current negotiations for the budget deal, defense and non-defense spending would get a boost of $50 billion in 2016 and $30 billion in 2017. Additionally, there would be a cap imposed on premium increases for Medicare Part B beneficiaries. Assuming the budget deal can be voted on this week in the House, it will pass only with overwhelming Democratic support. House Republicans are unlikely to support a compromise agreement. A deal would eliminate the issue of a government shutdown.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports under new rules to be considered by transportation officials in Sacramento, loud, smelly people could be asked to leave buses and light rail trains. The proposals come as Sacramento enjoys a downtown building boom that will eventually add a high-end basketball arena and a soccer stadium, amenities that officials hope will draw patrons to the area by light rail, bus, or train. A spokeswoman for the Sacramento Regional Transit District said, "If we can make it more attractive or make it more enjoyable to use the light rail or bus, then people are more apt to use it." Under the proposed ordinance, passengers will no longer be allowed to get on a bus or train unless they are covered, quote, above and below the waist and also wearing shoes. They will be banned from emitting a noxious odor unless the smell is related to a disability or a medical condition. Passengers will not be allowed to play sound equipment that is audible to other passengers and will be banned from sleeping on a train that has reached the end of its line. Those who refuse to comply could be kicked off the bus or train. But advocates for disadvantaged Sacramentans said the regulations were a swipe at homeless people who have a right to ride buses and trains. Pam Haney, advocacy coordinator for Wellsprings Women's Center in Sacramento, told the Sacramento Bee newspaper that she doubts anyone would be kicked off the bus for wearing too much high-end perfume. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Republicans back a plan for universal lawn care, and an RC car works up the courage to approach a group of girls. And now a recap of the week's news for those who like to waste their summers surfing the internet.
Fall, the long-running series of shorter days and cooler nights, was canceled this week after nearly 3 billion seasons on Earth. The classic period of the year, which once occupied the coveted slot between summer and winter, will be replaced by new stifling humidity levels and near-constant sunshine. A shiny, bobbing object in the water is generating fascination among members of the fish community, who have described it as pleasingly wiggly and minnow-esque. Aquatic experts say that decisive action must be taken against the object very soon. In local news, just when 27-year-old Andrew Sheets didn't think his vacation could get any better, a rerun of Spin City came on. And in other headlines, a bee stuck between the screen and front door is going f***ing nuts. And a water skier lets go of the crossbar to greet those not currently water skiing.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live. And this is Free Talk Live. You are invited to join us here. You can comment on the South Carolina attack against a student where a young lady was thrown backwards while still in her desk, flipping the desk back on her, with her, and then grabbed, pulled forward violently by this insane officer who has been sued twice before, and in one case for unnecessary violence on his case. The government here is alleging the student committed a crime, and we'll get into more of that here in moments, because she wasn't the only one arrested in the school that day in that classroom. Conan, you've got some details on that. We'll also analyze the reactions of the students to this scene, which was just absolutely horrifying, but yet they didn't really react at all. But I want to talk to Jim Babka, who is on the line with us. He's a longtime friend of the show. We've had him on more times than I can count. Normally, we don't have guests on, but Jim, somehow you managed to escape that rule, and we've had you on, like I said, more times than I can count. Because I really think that the activism you do is great work. You and I met first back, met, I guess, online, back when you were managing the Harry Brown campaign in the year 2000 for Libertarian for President. Since then, you've launched all kinds of wonderful projects like DownsizedDC.org, and your newest thing, Zero Aggression Project. Welcome back, Jim.
Thank you. I'm glad to be here, and I'm glad that I am grandfathered out of that rule. I love coming here.
Yeah, and
it's getting long enough that it's almost grandfatherly at this point.
No
We've
doubt.
Known each other a long time.
The Zero Aggression Project, let our listeners know what it is if they have yet to go to zeroaggressionproject.org. What will they find there?
It's a voluntarist libertarian initiative, and what we're trying to do is move the central idea of libertarianism, that it is bad to initiate coercive force against individuals, up to the front. You know, we asked ourselves, Ian, why this really, really powerful argument wasn't being used by libertarians, and then set out to try to find a way to present it much better, because we have an argument here, a principle that is so strong that if people agree to it, every other issue falls into place. If you and I have a debate about one issue, we can change each, maybe one or other of us can change each other's mind on that one issue. But it doesn't necessarily mean that we're a libertarian at the end of the conversation. But after we have this conversation, if you agree with the zero aggression principle, then all the other issues kind of fall into place. And so we felt it was important enough that we begin leading with it. We noticed that many libertarians had it in the back of their mind when they were having their conversations. They were using it to analyze and judge issues for themselves, but they weren't sharing it. We wanted to begin to bring this issue front and center. And the other thing was to create a very different kind of dialogue, because this is a dialogue that's based on a moral position. It's a moral philosophy. And most people believe themselves to be basically good, decent people. Mm-hmm. And they want you to believe they're good and decent people. They abide by things like the golden rule. So we wanted to put out this kind of silver rule, if you will, which doesn't say you have to do anything. It says don't do anything. Don't harm other people. We wanted to put that out there and say, okay, this is the standard. When you engage in politics, do you see how it's inconsistent? Do you see how your values, when you start expressing them in partisan terms, means someone has to be violated? Someone's conscience has to be violated. Someone's pursuit of happiness has to be damaged. Maybe even someone gets killed. And we think that's a very different kind of conversation that we can have too. And it makes the zero aggression principle a very, very powerful argument.
So I heard that you say when we engage in this conversation in politics, and does that mean that you think that any form, any involvement in the political process is somehow immoral?
No, actually, I went and placed my absentee ballot vote today because we have marijuana on our statewide ballot.
Really?
And oh, yeah. Yeah. Well, it's really bad here, though. They've got a proposal to set up a monopoly. so that only a handful of people can actually own the production, the means of production here in the state of Ohio.
Is this medical or legalization?
Full legalization, wow. but it's all very strictly controlled by this large monopoly. Ugh. And it's very, very disturbing. The Libertarian Party of Ohio and myself and others have said, you know, basically we don't think this monopoly thing is a good idea. We'd rather go the slower route of medical marijuana and watch that develop and evolve like it has mm-hmm. elsewhere than see some corporate conglomerate basically control the entire process. So anyway, I did vote, and I vote as a matter of self-defense in some cases. I don't usually vote for persons unless there's somebody I can truly embrace and agree with on the ballot, which is usually a libertarian candidate. But most of the time, I just go and vote on the ballot issues, and usually to vote to stop attacks or some expansion of government.
Yeah, it seems like zero aggression. The Zero Aggression Project is about communicating the base principle of libertarianism to people in an effective manner that can actually reach them.
Yeah, and you know, we've got these tools that we've created at our site, both our mental levers and our exceptions area. What do you think? But you know, the interactive polling tool. They're designed to be kind of passive tools in a way where you can sit and reflect on the ideas as opposed to a debate or an argument. I've noticed too over the years, and I think many libertarians would recognize what I'm saying as I say it, that not every libertarian has a good bedside manner. That there are some libertarians that you'd almost prefer they'd shut up.
Yes, yeah. Yes, yes.
So what we're looking for here is to put everything in a new, unique way. And the frame that we've put on almost everything is empathy. We believe that empathy is the source of your rights. That is, that you recognize that you don't want to be hurt, and then you begin to recognize that people you care about, you don't want them hurt, and you begin to extend that as you get more mature to your neighbors and people that you even see on the street. That this is the principle we abide by. In our day-to-day lives, we don't aggress against other people. We don't break their stuff. We don't steal their stuff. We don't go up and punch people in the mouth to get what we want, and that we need to connect this to our political reality. And so we want these tools in place so that people can share these ideas in social media settings, emails, conversations, whatever, but they can do it in a way maybe that's more sharing rather than threatening, more sharing rather than debating or arguing or I'm going to beat you in this opinion. And so that was a lot of the motivation for putting this together the way we did.
The website's really nice looking, zeroaggressionproject.org, but you're going to be presenting in reality here in Florida, and I wanted to give you a chance to quickly mention where and when and where can people go to learn more about it.
Well, thank you very much for doing that. I am, and this is my debut tour for the Zero Aggression Project to go present these ideas. Going to be giving a talk called How One Voluntarist Can Make Florida a Libertarian Place.
Yeah, right.
Well, I'll tell you what. You know, I think that libertarians have tried a lot of things that have been discouraging. And instead of success. And I think that there may be some very simple ideas that we could apply that could reverse that. And I want to share with people the power of one principle, one strategy, and one person. And I'll be doing it on Tuesday, November 3rd in Orlando at the Orlando Brewing on Atlanta Avenue. Wednesday, November 7th, I'll be at Shoeless Joe's in Fort Myers. That's at Bell Tower Drive. And Thursday, November 5th, I'll be at Peabody's on Amberley Drive in Tampa.
So now, nobody's writing that down. So where can they go to actually look at the dates?
Very good. They should go to the Zero Aggression Project, zeroaggressionproject.org. Go to the blog, and it's the second entry right now. It says Jim Babka on tour in Florida. And
I'm really curious. I hope there's a video of this, Jim, because I want to hear your pitch. I want to hear the whole thing. We don't have time for it tonight, but
I think it's a good speech and a good title, but not a good title for this speech.
You're talking with three former Floridians on the show tonight. By the way,
you'll enjoy it. We will have a video of it. In fact, when I get back home, we're gonna even maybe break down some of the pieces of it and present them in studio because I've been thinking long and hard about how to do this and what it's going to take for us to have a more libertarian country. And I really do think it starts with the heart. So these ideas at Zero Aggression Project, unlike the stuff we do at Downsize DC, where we're lobbying Congress, has much more to do with changing an individual heart, winning the battleground of their mind and the precinct of their conscience.
I love it. I think you're doing good work, even if I don't think Florida has a chance in hell of becoming any more libertarian.
That's right. I would love to come to New Hampshire and give the talk How One Voluntarist Can Make New Hampshire.
Well, here we have hundreds of them. I don't know how many of them there are in Florida at this point, because a bunch of them have moved here. We actually just had the Arkansas Libertarian chairman, a former libertarian chair, or the former chair of the Libertarian Party in Arkansas. He and his wife just made the move here to New Hampshire. They just showed up today. So we had several people come out and do a meet and greet with them. And this is one of the things that you're really working against down in Florida. And I know you don't live there, but in all the other 49 states you're working against is sort of the Free State Project brain drain, if you will, where some of the best activists are just packing it up and saying, let's see, do I want to be where there are 20 activists or do I want to be where there are 2,000 of them? And right now we're coming up close on 20,000 signers here for the Free State Project. We're at 88% of that goal, and it's going up about 1% per month now, which is pretty exciting. So Probably at about this time next year, unless things get faster, we'll have hit that goal of 20,000. Hopefully one of these days we'll see you sooner rather than later, Jim. I always appreciate your time, man. Thanks for being on Free Talk Live.
I love being here. Thanks, guys.
Thanks, dude. That's Jim Babka from the Zero Aggression Project at zeroaggressionproject.org. If you're in Florida, go see him next week. Details are on his blog.
You can control your health care with Liberty Health Share.
Liberty Health Share is like-minded people coming together to share medical costs, which saves money.
You don't even have to pay for procedures that violate your conscience.
Because we all share the same values.
Join the movement of people who share in medical costs and change the way you pay for your health care forever.
Go to libertyhealthshare.org to find out more.
Liberty Health Share.
Together, we're changing health care for good. libertyhealthshare.org.
There comes a time when you need custom embroidered or screen printed apparel for your business, organization, or a special event. Corporate Casuals has been helping people create great looking logoed apparel for over 25 years. They can produce a single piece or thousands using name brand apparel like Nike, Patagonia, Adidas, and Hanes. Create your logo in their online embroidery design studio or upload your existing logo and they'll turn it into embroidery. Go to corporatecasuals.com/FTL and include FTL in the order notes and save 5% on your order.
Are you tired of commuting to a job that makes someone else rich, working harder than ever, but getting nowhere? Do you hate spending hundreds of dollars every week on daycare, having someone else raise your children? With our opportunities, you can start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss, work from home, and live a happier life. At Be the Boss Network, you'll find hundreds of work-from-home opportunities that you can literally start today and be earning money as soon as next week. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss. Get out of the rat race. Work from home. Go to freedom106.com right now and change your life today. That's freedom, the number 106.com. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You be the boss. Go to freedom106.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You can join us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. Mark, you're getting all packed up, ready to head out. What is it, bright and early tomorrow?
Oh, man, it's not bright. I wish it was bright. We're leaving at 3:15 a.m. Yeah.
That's when the flight takes off?
No, the flight's at like...
So you're leaving the house.
5 o'clock or something like that. And we gotta...
That's about as early as it gets.
Yeah, it's not pleasant particularly. But if you want to go to Las Vegas, and that's where the Bitcoin Investor Conference is, I definitely want to go.
Right. The Bitcoin Investor Conference, the first ever, starts on Thursday. So you're flying up Wednesday. You'll get there enough time to fall asleep and then go to the conference, right?
Well, we're going to – my wife wants to hike Red Rock, so she gets to, you know, she gets to pick one thing that we do, and so that's what she gets. I'm a good husband. Yeah, I let him do one thing.
That's great.
So nonetheless, we're going
to – Wait. You were telling me a joke earlier this evening about you being a good husband.
Who knows what I said.
Something about a dog and your wife in a closet.
I think it was locking them in a trunk to see which one loves you more.
And then going back a day later, and the one that comes, the one that's most glad to see you when you open the door is the one that loves you the
most. It's a Facebook meme, and it's hilarious. If you, the suggestion is, if you lock your wife or your dog in the trunk, the one that loves you the most is the one that's happy to see you, happiest to see you when you get out. And I can only imagine. I showed it to my wife, and
I don't think she was very happy.
I laughed and laughed.
Only one will result in a criminal charge as well.
Right, exactly. Yeah. All kinds of reasons not to lock your wife in a trunk.
Bitcoininvestor.com. It starts Thursday, goes through Friday.
Yep, it's at the D Hotel in downtown Las Vegas. There'll be lots of great speakers telling you how to invest surrounding Bitcoin. You know, different businesses to invest in, how to make money. There's going to be
of opportunities. Yeah, that's for sure.
Plenty of opportunities. I imagine there'll be some VC there too, venture capitalists.
Yep.
So it's bitcoininvestor.com to get your tickets. You still can get them before you go to the door, bitcoininvestor.com.
You will be broadcasting live on Thursday and Friday nights.
That's correct.
This Thursday and Friday. So let's continue here. The discussion around what happened in South Carolina in a classroom there with a school resource officer, Officer Ben Fields, who is not his first time being accused of excessive force. He basically walks up to a young lady, says something to her like, so I treated you fairly last year, or do you remember me treating you fairly last year? She says, I don't know you. And he says, well, you know, blah, 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 and then just basically throws her out of the chair. He says he's going to help her out of the chair and then throws her backward while she's still in this desk, which is hard to get out of when you've got a man standing in front of the area that you have to exit, right? Because there's only one way out of this desk. It's the desk with the bar on the right-hand side,
yeah,
and you enter in from the left-hand side of the desk. Well, there's a cop standing right there. So it's not like she could just pop right up out of the desk with him standing there. But nonetheless, she wasn't wanting to move. There's no doubt about that.
She wasn't going, okay, let me get up,
Yeah, but at the same time, he didn't really give her a chance. He didn't threaten her in any way. It didn't sound like he was going to be violent with her. He just grabs her all of a sudden and slams her backwards while the entire class is sitting there watching. And Conan, you had some thoughts, some observations on what the other students were, or rather were not doing in class.
Either these kids, because they are all calmly sitting, hands in laps. One guy's got, he actually puts his head in his hands and just is looking down. The other adult in the room who was called on to get rid of to ask the girl from the room first,
the administrator,
he steps back because he doesn't want to get this girl thrown into him.
Yep.
But everyone's just sitting there calmly. My question is, are these kids so used to this type of behavior that it's just everyday common day routine for them, or is this girl just a regular troublemaker and they're used to seeing her getting thrown out of classes on a regular basis, and this is just, you know, or maybe this is their daily lives, maybe not in the school necessarily, but once they leave the school, are they, you know, regularly affronted with this type of behavior, people getting beat on?
It's rare for people to get too upset with a villain getting, you know, sort of somebody being physical with a villain. And if this gal was sufficiently an a-hole during the class, then she likely turned the attitude of the class against her. And that's kind of what I'm seeing in this video.
I don't believe it. I mean, I understand that's what the attitude is of one of the videographers. There were three different angles. We read the comments from one of them, the one that got the closest up version of this.
And I don't think that somebody who's an a-hole should be thrown around bodily.
That's my point. He took the side of the cop. But had I been in that classroom, I was not necessarily a fan of the police and how they treated people. I certainly wasn't as adamant about it then as I am today. But I don't feel like I would have found that to be acceptable at all.
And by the way, the other, the girl who was arrested, the friend, Nia Kenny, an 18-year-old, who stood up and had all this, she had all this knowledge of what had taken place. That's why they said they arrested her, because she had so much to say, quote. No, she actually admitted that she wasn't participating in class. She had her cell phone out. Yep. She wasn't listening to anybody. So she admits that this girl was,
she'd be in a brat.
She was
no
playing,
doubt.
She was playing the fool. And,
but this, she didn't deserve what happened to her.
No,
at all.
Of course not. But I mean, but we don't know how many other times, during her school life, they're probably both 18. We're talking, you know, at least 4 years here that this, resource officer with a hot temper has probably had to deal with her. And so, I mean, we're not seeing a whole lot of what has taken place.
No doubt.
Throwing her out of a chair, dragging her across the room, no, it's no good. But, I mean, this kid is probably no good also.
Well, we don't know what, I mean, she says, he says that he was fair with her in the past, but she says that she doesn't know him.
Yeah.
So
maybe he don't even know who she
maybe
is.
Maybe that's her response anytime she's talking to the man.
Could be.
I don't know who you are. Yeah. You're not my daddy.
It could be, but I mean, you know, I have no particular reason to believe that the school resource officer knows who this girl is. I mean, you have to start from zero, and zero is these two people don't know each other. Just because the police officer says, "Didn't I treat you fairly last year?" doesn't mean he knows who he's talking to. You know, there's a great deal of scientific evidence out there that suggests that people of different races have a difficult time sort of identifying individuals and age and things like that. So I don't know what we're dealing with.
I don't know you.
Okay, you're going to come with me or am I going to make you?
You're going to come with me or am I going to make you?
Come on,
I'm going to get you up. And then bam!
Less than 3 seconds.
Bam! Swings are backwards. Desk flies back. Pulls her forward. She's still inside the desk. Yanks on her to get her out from behind the desk. I mean, there's just no way this is acceptable. So here's my speculation on why the class is the way they are. And by the way, Conan, you'll see this in a lot of places, not just in classes, but just in public.
You'll see it on the street.
Right.
Yeah. Someone will walk up, have a debate with someone. It gets a little rowdy, and they start throwing punches. And people just stand there and they watch.
Well, I mean, specifically when the police are attacking people on the streets, people will stand there and do nothing about it because, one, you're scared. You know, you don't know what this cop's going to do to you if you step forward.
Number two, they've got a uniform on, so they must be right.
Well, I don't know. There's obviously people have different opinions. But even of the people who think this is wrong, you know, they know that you'll get charged with something.
And he's got a gun on his hip, and he might just happen to use it.
He might hurt you next, but the other girl, the one girl, we can't play the part of the video, but I presume the girl who got charged is the girl who starts talking and says the S word here in this video. She got charged criminally with a misdemeanor for that, for speaking out. It's Free Talk Live.
So you've got to take a state construction license exam or certification. Can't decide on what books or what chapters to study? Discover right now how you can eliminate unnecessary books and wasted study time. At contractorexam.com, our study materials zero in on state-required test topics in an effective, multiple-choice format. So whether you're a plumber, electrician, general contractor, or other construction-related trade, contractorexam.com will help get you prepared. Visit us at www.contractorexam.com today.
You heard the discussions all over the radio. You couldn't believe what you were hearing. You trusted them. How could you have not seen the signs? You felt betrayed. Outrage set in. Your emotions began to consume you. Then, nothing. Now they're talking football. Days turned to weeks and months. Then, you've forgotten. But they haven't. They're still monitoring your every move. It's coming. Monitor blockitpocket.com. Or will you forget?
If you're looking for work, the person you are applying to is probably so swamped with applicants that he or she is tough to reach. So call early in the day, before 8 a.m., before the palace guards arrive. You'll need your prospect's direct number, and here's a sneaky way to get it. Suppose the company's main number is 555-5000. You should call 555-5012. When someone says, "Good morning, Pam Johnson," you should innocently say, "Oops, somebody here must have written this down wrong. I was calling for Tom Frederick. What's his direct number?" If the very next thing you hear isn't Pam giving you Tom's number, it may be, "Good morning, Tom Frederick." For more tips for job seekers and getting better results in all your day-to-day communication, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Lil Drums. Every bit as fun as a full-size Nestle drumstick cone and definitely cuter. Visit us at drumstick.com. Vacations are all about family time, but you don't have to leave home to have fun. Take one weekend a month and devote it to family activities. Pull out the board games and puzzles, serve up some treats, or have a picnic. Even without leaving home, you'll feel like you've really had some time away. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Free Talk Live.
I'm sure I can speak for many of thousands. I don't fear illegals. I don't want them here and their filth that they bring with and the disease that they bring with.
All the people who work in the stores and the markets and the restaurants are overwhelmingly Hispanic, and they seem very clean and be doing a fine job here, and I've never heard anything about problems with disease.
For you to defend the illegal immigrants, and I'm not sure, as I said earlier, which host at what time is very condescending.
Madam, I will defend anybody that is peaceful and looking for a better life for themselves. I don't defend them.
I wish that people like you.
You say that Mexicans are filthy and you call me condescending, lady? You say they're disease-ridden and filthy and I'm condescending?
And they are.
You're outrageous. Get out of here. Thank you for the call.
She's had all her rope. She's hung herself.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM. You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, join us right here. Toll-free number for you, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And also Skype into the show. Skype username is lrn.fm. We are discussing in detail the situation in South Carolina with a cop, sheriff's deputy, Ben Fields, who is hopefully going to get into some kind of trouble for this. The sheriff is not, in his statements, the sheriff is not exactly sounding like he's siding immediately with his officer.
It's only the third time he's pretty much flipped out and just taken the law into his own hands, demolition style.
Yeah.
Stallone style. I'm just going to, hey, you know what? You're talking to me?
You're right. It was kind of very Stallone-esque. It seems like something you'd see him do in a movie, just slamming somebody backwards like that.
We apologize deeply to all of our Italian-American listeners.
I wasn't trying to do it. I just slipped out the tongue, Mark.
I'm just kidding you.
So we'll get back into that here in moments. We were listening to the rest of the video there a moment ago, which we can't play on the air due to some profanity, from a young lady who was observing.
Well, you can handle a little profanity?
I can handle it, but I don't know if the FCC would like it very much if our radio stations played that. I mean, we could argue, Mark, that it's news, and so therefore it shouldn't be edited. But
I don't think you can argue that with our problem isn't the FCC. Our problem is radio stations and how they can handle that. Yeah,
that's true. So anyway, we'll get back into that here in a moment. I also want to let you know how you can get some business cards, 500 of them, for $9.99, starting at $9.99. You can add in some bonuses like fancy, you know, fancy factors like a metallic spot gloss or raised print, because Vistaprint.com can do it however you want it. They'll customize your text, colors, backsides. You can even upload your logo to one of their existing designs or upload an entire design on your own. Their tool makes it super easy. And if you don't just need business cards, maybe you want postcards, flyers, banners, apparel, invitations. Man, whatever you need for your home or office needs, they can help you out. And they've got amazing custom design services. So if you need to hire them to do some work for you, they can do that. And they guarantee that you'll love your products every time or they'll make it right. It's an amazing customer service experience over there at Vistaprint.com. And it's, again, 500 business cards starting at just $9.99. It's a fantastic deal, and it's up to 50% savings over regular site pricing. So what you do to get the deal is you go to Vistaprint.com, create and design your custom business cards, and then use code FTL at checkout. That's like Free Talk Live. Code FTL to get 500 business cards starting at just $9.99 at Vistaprint.com.
Now, is this a one-time deal, or can you do this multiple times as long as you type in FTL every time?
That I suspect is an introductory offer, Conan, yeah. But I don't have those details. I imagine if it was being shipped to a second address, then they probably wouldn't know. But that's up to you to discover. We just give you the discount code FTL at Vistaprint.com. So the video is pretty outrageous. It was filmed from three different angles, and Conan, you were disturbed by the lack of reaction, the seeming lack of reaction from the class.
I found it curious,
and,
you know.
I am not surprised at all, having seen how people react to the police in general. Some of them do believe the police are always right, so we can take those people out from the discussion. But for the people that were shocked and outraged by this, but yet still sitting in the class observing it, there are multiple reasons why they wouldn't have necessarily had spoken out. One
right.
is they probably didn't want to get beaten by the cop. Two is they probably didn't want to get a criminal charge, because odds are good. You know, we're talking about a high school. Maybe these are juniors or seniors. You said one of the girls was 18, according to the news story. So these are older high school students who've likely been around long enough to see other classmates get taken out in handcuffs. Because obviously with this disturbing school criminal charge, that's what it's called in South Carolina, disturbing schools. It's an actual misdemeanor charge, which means that this probably isn't the first time one of their classmates have been charged with it. Where, you know, when we were growing up, and maybe in some school districts it's still this way, but when we were growing up, if you disturbed a classroom or disturbed the school, you'd be sent to the principal's office, and there'd be some kind of in-school suspension or punishment that
You'd be picking up trash on the weekend. They don't call the resource officer, a uniformed cop in,
right.
to actually fine you, to actually write out a fine.
So the penalty would not
call
have
your parents
been,
in.
For us to speak up would not have been a severe penalty. But for these students to speak up, one of the girls did. There was one girl that you can hear in the video later who uses the S word and seems upset about what she's witnessing. Why'd you do that kind of thing? They charged her with the same charge as the girl who would not get out of the chair. Now, the girl who wouldn't get out of the chair obviously was causing an issue. The other girl was just reacting to what the police did. But the girl who reacted got charged as well. So the students know that if you step out of line at school, you get hit with a misdemeanor criminal charge. And that means going to court. And that means juvenile justice. And that means, you know, whatever the penalties are for that.
Whatever the problems are that there are for standing up. And what's the value, particularly, for standing up? You know, there's not.
Well, there's a value for standing up for innocent people who are attacked by the police. It's letting the police know that that is unacceptable. I do it all the time when I'm out on the streets and I see the police harassing innocent people. I let them know that I don't appreciate what they're doing. And if more people would do that, then I think it would give important feedback to those police. But in this environment, this is prison. And if the prisoners start to get upset, then they're going to get in trouble with the warden.
And the next thing you know, the entire prison is on lockdown, and
right.
and they're all losing their privileges. So some knucklehead, this girl in particular, causes much pain and suffering for the rest of the prisoners, and
right.
no one wants that. So
they're scared.
So it's all right to throw her under the bus, and hey, as long as we can come back tomorrow and everything is hunky-dory, and we go back to being, you know, kind of slaves.
I don't think they all wanted to throw her under the bus. I mean, you had three different video streams here, Conan.
Yeah, and it's funny. She was in trouble. The main offense that she committed was she had her cell phone out.
So three other people got their phones out and surreptitiously recorded what happened. And as far as I'm concerned, I don't expect a kid to go to get catch a misdemeanor charge for standing up for another young person. That I can't expect. But to record video of it, I think that was absolutely the right thing to do in that particular case, because otherwise there would have been no evidence of how this cop performed in this class. This would not have become national news. It would have just been the rumor around the school.
It would have been his word against everyone else.
Right. The students around the school would have been talking about it. Maybe some people would have seen their posts on Facebook, but that's it.
And for all we know, the other two offenses that he committed, maybe that's exactly what happened. No one had their camera.
That's right.
2 years ago, whenever he
case dismissed
when he was road raging on someone.
I think there is a picture of him when he was taking down the active duty military individual mm-hmm. that, and then sprayed, emptied a can of stripper paint
on the back
face.
Of their neck.
Yeah. Oh my God, he did that.
Mm-hmm.
That's the story.
Wow. When I read the summary, it didn't come off that way. So disturbing schools. We never actually got through the full statute here. So it shall be unlawful, they say, for any person willfully or unnecessarily, A, to interfere with or disturb in any way or in any place the students or teachers of any school or college in this state, or to loiter about such a school or premises, or to act in an obnoxious manner thereon. Part 2. It is also unlawful for any person to A, enter upon any such school or college premises, or B, loiter around the premises, except on business, without the permission of the principal or president in charge.
No passing out flyers at this school, Ian. They've already,
right.
They're already prepared for activists.
Yeah, and it does say here that, well, I mean, I've given out flyers on the outside of schools, but it includes colleges here, and I've given out flyers on college campus multiple times. And have never been threatened with arrest for that.
Right. If there's any place you could hand out flyers, you think it would be, you know, higher learning academies.
The supposed bastions of free speech that they are.
As long as you're standing in your free speech square.
They've tried to give me trouble for it on a couple of occasions, but they leave me alone these days. Part B here. So this is part B of A, B, and C under disturbing schools. Any person violating any of the provisions of this section shall be guilty of a misdemeanor, and on conviction thereof shall pay a fine of not more than $1,000.
Holy mackerel.
Or be imprisoned in county jail for not more than 90 days.
90 days for being obnoxious?
That's correct. Part C, the summary courts are vested with the jurisdiction to hear and dispose cases involving a violation.
One of these problems with charges these days is that they feel like they have to have higher, you know, more and more severe charges just to get the prosecutors to go after them. Prosecution and law enforcement is so overloaded that it, you know, they just have to keep on ramping up the charges, and it gets ridiculous.
Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Currency is too important a thing to be left in the hands of government bureaucrats, especially when billions of dollars can be created with the swipe of a pen. Overstock.com supports the cryptocurrency movement because it returns the power of an inflation-proof money to the people where it belongs. Did you know that you can use Bitcoin to pay for anything Overstock.com sells while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more? If you support freedom in the cryptocurrency movement, you should support Overstock.com.
KDArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period, with packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order. Why would you go anywhere else? KD offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KDArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free water purification kit for a limited time with any body armor package. Go to KDArmor.com. That's EATIArmor.com. Come and take it.
A revolution in body protection has arrived only at FortressSurvivalLLC.com. Introducing the revolutionary patented Level 3 Bulletproof Vest. 100% Kevlar, 100% American made. Concealable, fully adjustable, and the lowest price on the market. Adult size normally $289.99, now just $250. Kid size normally $239.99, now just $200. Get affordable protection with a Level 3A Bulletproof Vest from FortressSurvivalLLC.com. For thou art my rock and my fortress. Psalm 31:3.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Well, George, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring Simon to their rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think you are?
Excuse me.
There is no video and audio allowed in this
office. No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't gonna make...
Wait,
you wanna
go. Now. Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you scared me!
Property. What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men
working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateurs, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. The absurdities continue. We've been talking throughout the night tonight about the scene in South Carolina in one classroom where a teenage girl was attacked violently and completely unnecessarily by a police officer, a deputy of the sheriff's, who has had incidents previously with violence, and now he's got another one where he flips a girl backwards as she's in her desk. She won't get out of her chair, so he uses unnecessary force, flips her backwards. The chair goes back with her. He pulls her as she's on the ground, manages to get her out of the chair, and then ultimately cuffs her. And it's just a shocking video. We've included it on our Facebook and Twitter. You can go and see that. Go to news.freetalklive.com to pull up our social websites. Again, news.freetalklive.com. But the insanity continues with Ademo and Brian from the Cop Block Mac Tour. Mobile Accountability for Cops is what that stands for. They've been on the road now for several weeks maybe at this point. And it was about 10 days ago when Ademo was arrested on a warrant. They were in Kansas at the time on the Mac Tour. And Ademo was arrested on a warrant out of Noblesville, Indiana, which is where they were the day before they kicked off the tour. I think it was earlier this month, or maybe it was mid-September. Anyway, they were in Noblesville, and they had chalked the Noblesville Police Department at that time. And Noblesville police, even though they confronted the two about the chalking, they did not make any arrests. They issued a warrant later on, and then Ademo was arrested in Kansas. Hmm. Ademo bailed out. And then they decided to go back to Indiana, to go to Noblesville, where they would then turn themselves in on these warrants. Because there's actually a warrant for Brian Sumner as well. So it's Ademo Freeman and Brian Sumner.
Both for chalking.
The charge is criminal mischief.
Ugh.
And they were lied to at first. Ademo was told it was a felony charge at first, which is why he bailed out. He thought it was going to be felony, which meant he'd been held for a long time and extradited. Turns out it wasn't a felony charge. He was lied to by multiple bureaucrats in that case. And it's a misdemeanor, but it's still, you know, ridiculous. They chalked using what's called liquid chalk. And they've actually made a video of the liquid chalk where they're testing the liquid chalk in different types of concrete and mm-hmm. for different periods
video,
of time.
What are the results of this video?
I haven't had a chance to watch the full 9 minutes, Mark.
Okay.
But presumably the results are that the chalk comes off. I don't know for sure, but I would imagine if the chalk didn't come off, they probably wouldn't have released a video with tests because you wouldn't want to make evidence against yourself.
Yeah, I would agree with that.
And these guys certainly are no dummies. So anyway, the warrants, they wanted to take care of the warrants. They wanted to go back to Noblesville to clear up these warrants for this nonsense. And that means going and turning themselves in. That's what they did last night. We heard from them. They announced it here on this show on Saturday night. They went to Noblesville. There was an activist from Ohio who went with them and another one from Indiana. So there were two camera people recording the scene out in front of Noblesville Police Department. The video is up now over at freekeen.com. It's also over at copblock.org. Freekeen.com, you can see the video of them being arrested in front of Noblesville PD. But it actually took them 20 minutes before the police actually came out. So they had plenty of time to chalk again in front of the police department, chalking various police accountability messages out front. So 20 minutes into this, they then call 911 on themselves to let the police know that, you know, two wanted
criminals. It's cold out here, guys.
That probably wasn't a good idea. That probably get them for something for, I don't know, using
false 911 report.
Yeah, false 911 report.
It wouldn't surprise me if they hit them with that charge. And maybe they, you know, that's what I heard was that they called 911, but I don't know for sure. Maybe they called the back line because usually there's like another number you can call. But actually, here in Keene, New Hampshire, when you call the police's back line, the regular local number, not the 911, it says in their automated message to press 0, like right up front, it says press 0 if this is an emergency. Then later, it tells you after giving you the voicemail numbers and everything, the different options that you can dial, they then say press 0 to talk to the dispatcher. So even if it's a non-emergency, you're supposed to press 0 either way. So when I first called that number, I thought, am I going to get charged if I hit 0 now rather than wait through the end of this message?
Yeah.
Anyway, so they called 911 on themselves, and then there were 7 to 9 officers, so more than a half a dozen officers were dispatched to deal with the chalkers. And they came out, and there's
maybe during that 20 minutes they were strategizing. Like, all right, look, we've watched these guys' YouTube videos. We know who they are. All right, we need 7. Yeah,
to the officers,
battle rattle up.
To the officers' credit, they were relatively okay as far as, you know, they didn't rough them up or anything like that. Of course, they also had 2 video cameras on them.
Yes, exactly. They had video on them. This is why video is so good. Yes. It makes us all better people.
Right.
It really does.
In the case of the South Carolina cop, he did not know he was being recorded.
He
in the
not.
Case of the Noblesville police, they did know that they were being recorded. And one of the cops in the video actually talks about how he's aware of cell 411, and he watched one of the cop blockers' videos about this, because the guys over at copblock.org at the Mac Tour are constantly making videos, although not now because they're in jail.
They're good marketers.
But they talked about the cell 411 app, which is an awesome app. I've got it. I don't know if either of you have it yet, but you should have it. If you're an activist, you should have cell 411. It's an awesome app. It's 99 cents on iPhone and Android and allows you to send out notices to your friends. So if you're getting arrested or if you're having a nasty interaction with the cops, it could lead to your arrest. You send a notice about that. Or if it's a fire or a medical emergency, lots of different choices. You send that notice out, and then your friends who've subscribed also will receive those. And so the cop was actually aware of cell 411, which is kind of cool. So some of them are actually spending the time to research the people that they're arresting. And that can only lead to good things, mm-hmm. I think. Having
good police work.
Yeah, I think having the police come across messages of freedom is generally a good thing to do.
But they also have, like, rate your professor. And I knew many professors who had actually go and frequent this site to see how the students were rating them. And they would actually, it was good feedback for them, so that they, if so-and-so neighbor teacher down the street was acting up, they would know ahead of time that, yeah, this is a problem, professor. And they would also be able to, it was good criticism.
Maybe this shows us my bias towards adults, because I admittedly, I've got a bias towards adults against kids. I feel like if you have never worked for a living, that you shouldn't be rating people who've worked for a living.
Yes, I guess you're going to have to take this with a grain of salt. This is all students who are rating you, unless you're going to the community college, and then you could, you know, you same site, rate your professor, but you would already probably know that, yeah, most of these guys are at least 10 years older.
The community college?
Oh, you better believe it.
The community college where I'm from was 13th and 14th grade. I mean, it wasn't anything special at all.
I also took like night classes, so it was people getting off of work. And it was the only time available to them that, you know, their kids are, you know, and being taken care of at the babysitter. And I was always in class with older adults. It wasn't until I went to State College in Tennessee, and it was, there was the 13th grade there. It was horrible.
Oh, man. So you can join us, share your thoughts at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. If you want to see Ademo and Brian's arrest video, it's up right now, freekeen.com, also copblock.org. Word is their pretrial. So there was some word that their trial was going to be December 8th. It's actually apparently the pretrial that's on December 8th, which that's a long way away for a pretrial conference. I mean, that's more than a month away at this point. And
why not just let them sit, right?
And then trial date is January 14th. They face a maximum of 6 months in jail for this charge, for this criminal mischief charge for using washable chalk. And by the way, in the video, the videographer, or one of the videographers later, I don't know if you can hear it in the video, but later one of the videographers mentioned on his Facebook page, Jordan Freshour, he mentions that Jordan Freshour mentions on his Facebook page that he's watching as the police are washing the chalk away, and it's washing away easily. So, you know, he was there when they had the hoses out later on. So after they arrested Ademo and Brian, the cops milled around for a while, you know, talking about what they were going to do, and asking the cameramen if the cameramen chalked, because they wanted to arrest them too for something. You know, if you tell the cops you did something that they want you to, you know, if they're asking you if you did
something,
you do, tell
don't
them yes.
Don't stand up for the guy who was chalking, because that you're going to become an accessory. You're going to
No, they stood up for them.
Oh, did they?
Yeah, this isn't school. This is outside of the police department, so you can certainly use your free speech there. That has not been restricted yet. You certainly should and can stand up for people in public when they're being assaulted.
You said that in the last segment.
Police.
Definitely, if you see someone getting taken down, don't be that guy who's just standing there watching it and then going home and saying, I was outraged. I saw this happen just, you know, 15 minutes ago. I can't believe they did. No, instead of talking about it later on, I mean, really stand up for your fellow human being. And
they definitely did that in this video. If you see something, say something. Turn the government.
Well, it works. It works
them.
Both ways, doesn't it?
If you see something, record it and say something.
If you see something, blog it.
So,
and YouTube it.
Free Talk Live, your go-to source for chalking news.
The war on chalk, man. There's a serious war on chalk going on here, and it's a war on freedom of expression. 855-450-FREE, that's our number, and this is Free Talk Live.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
You can control your health care with Liberty HealthShare.
Liberty HealthShare is like-minded people coming together to share medical costs, which saves money.
You don't even have to pay for procedures that violate your conscience.
Because we all share the same values.
Join the movement of people who share in medical costs and change the way you pay for your health care forever.
Go to libertyhealthshare.org to find out more.
Liberty HealthShare.
Together, we're changing health care for good. libertyhealthshare.org.
This is your Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Tuesday, gold is even at $1,164 per ounce, and silver is even at $15.91 per ounce. Bitcoin is currently trading at $293. Roberts & Roberts Brokerage, a trusted name in precious metals since 1977. When you're serious about precious metals, give us a call at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.co.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 3 is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, October 27th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.88 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,166 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $292. Antiwar.com reports Kurdish forces for the People's Protection Units, YPG, and the Free Syrian Army forces who were fighting alongside them reported they came repeatedly under fire from Turkish soldiers across the border into Tel Abyan, a town the Kurds recently seized from the Islamic State and absorbed into the Kobani Canton. According to the forces on the ground, they repeatedly came under brief machine gun fire from the Turkish side of the border, but did not return fire on the Turkish soldiers. Turkey has not directly addressed this report, but did hint at their involvement. Turkish President Erdogan blasted the YPG for its recent gains in his comments, vowing Turkey will do whatever is necessary and accusing the YPG of secretly being in league with the Islamic State, despite having taken territory directly from the Islamic State. Turkey has long opposed the growth of the YPG and complained bitterly about U.S. and Russian support for them against the Islamic State. Turkey appears to believe a larger YPG territory will add to secessionist sentiment in southeastern Turkey, where the Turkish military is carrying out a war against Kurdish separatists.
You can support FPP Radio by shopping online. Whether you're looking for precious metals, bitcoins, or books, you'll find that and more at shop.fppradio.com. Every purchase you make from one of my affiliates, like Namecheap and Amazon, at shop.fppradio.com helps fund FPP Radio. Or you can shop directly from FPP with Bitcoin in the Bitcoin store. That's shop.fppradio.com.
UPI reports congressional leaders and White House officials are reportedly nearing an agreement on a 2-year budget as well as lifting the debt ceiling. Officials have until November 3rd to raise the debt limit before the U.S. Treasury says it will run out of money. The deadline to fund the federal government is December 3rd. Also under consideration are measures to fund highway and infrastructure construction, which must be renewed by the end of the week, and renew the Export-Import Bank for another year after it lapsed over the summer. Under current negotiations for the budget deal, defense and non-defense spending would get a boost of $50 billion in 2016 and $30 billion in 2017. Additionally, there would be a cap imposed on premium increases for Medicare Part B beneficiaries. Assuming the budget deal can be voted on this week in the House, it will pass only with overwhelming Democratic support. House Republicans are unlikely to support a compromise agreement. A deal would eliminate the issue of a government shutdown.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports under new rules to be considered by transportation officials in Sacramento, loud, smelly people could be asked to leave buses and light rail trains. The proposals come as Sacramento enjoys a downtown building boom that will eventually add a high-end basketball arena and a soccer stadium, amenities that officials hope will draw patrons to the area by light rail, bus, or train. A spokeswoman for the Sacramento Regional Transit District said, "If we can make it more attractive or make it more enjoyable to use the light rail or bus, bus, then people are more apt to use it. Under the proposed ordinance, passengers will no longer be allowed to get on a bus or train unless they are covered, quote, above and below the waist and also wearing shoes. They will be banned from emitting a noxious odor unless the smell is related to a disability or a medical condition. Passengers will not be allowed to play sound equipment that is audible to other passengers and will be banned from sleeping on a train that has reached the end of its line. Those who refuse to comply could be kicked off the bus or train. But advocates for disadvantaged Sacramentans said the regulations were a swipe at homeless people who have a right to ride buses and trains. Pam Haney, advocacy coordinator for Wellsprings Women's Center in Sacramento, told the Sacramento Bee newspaper that she doubts anyone would be kicked off the bus for wearing too much high-end perfume. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Despite a long-held consensus pointing to the mid-20s as the final stage of brain maturation, a new study has found that the adolescent brain doesn't fully form until boys have avenged their father's murder.
New imaging studies suggest that the frontal cortex goes through extensive changes during the period of training when an adolescent boy prepares himself to track down and kill the man who took his father's life. But it's not until the boy stares deep into the murderer's eyes and then stabs him right in the heart that the two lobes fuse into a fully mature brain.
According to Dr. Lori's findings, the myelin surrounding the teenage nerve synapses develops when boys stake out the home of their father's murderer, put themselves through grueling physical training, and fantasize again and again about how satisfying it will be when he finally makes the bastard who took everything from him beg for his life.
Now, if they let their father's killer slip through their grasp, or if they press the barrel of a gun to the back of his head and then realize they don't have what it takes to pull the trigger, then the amygdala is definitively stunted, and they'll have lifelong problems interpreting emotional information.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
This is Free Talk Live. We're launching into the third hour of the program, and you can join us here on the radio. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you in studio, you've got me, Ian.
And Conan.
And Mark.
And, of course, you can join us online. Just drop by freetalklive.com. It is a brand-new website. You can go and get interactive. freetalklive.com. You get to submit content right there to the front page of the site, just like you've always been able to do over the last half a decade, but it looks better now. It's a little bit slicker. It's tweaked. It's improved, and I hope you like it. Go and enjoy. You can download, of course, as many episodes of the show as you want. That's all free at freetalklive.com. Michelle Seven is on the line, a.k.a. Bitcoin Bell. Hey, Michelle Seven.
Hey. I'm retiring Bitcoin Bell soon, by the way. I'm just going back to Michelle Seven. Yeah, she was an experiment that for a couple years, and it was fun, but I'm ready to retire. But I have some...
You okay?
My brother. Yes. I'm
no,
so
you're
happy.
You're happy?
Yes.
Okay.
So, my brother... So I heard that you were talking about the young woman who in the high school was picked up and thrown down by the cop. And I've, of course, seen that video and everything.
It's atrocious.
You know, a few people know about my life when I was younger and my brothers and stuff. But we kind of, we've been dealing with the state since we were like 11 and 12. Easy, you're younger than I am. And so I have lots of reasons to hate the state that are empirical and everything. And Tony really has suffered tremendously. He's had been beaten a couple times by cops and had brain damage and just some really horrible things. And last January, he was picked up after he made a threat to a man, Randy, I think you pronounce his last name, Heisek or something. He is the CEO of TRX, the exercise equipment that is very popular. And the reason Tony made this threat was because Tony claims to have invented the equipment first. He did invent the equipment first, but they might have, I mean, I don't know. I mean, maybe Randy said he invented it while he was a Navy SEAL over in Iraq or something, and Tony has proof that he made it first, but Randy probably, I mean, whatever. I don't know. I don't know anything about that. But in any case, Tony was convinced that his idea was stolen. And so after trying to you know, go to this man and whatever. He finally just said, well, I'm going to come get your money, which I don't advise people doing that. He did threaten him. I think that that's wrong. I think that's bad and everything. However, Tony has plenty of issues, and really prison for 25 years was really not going to be a solution. And that's what he was looking at. And he was picked up in a Salt Lake City, taken to San Francisco, which is where he was going to be tried. And they sent him to North Carolina to Butner Federal Prison Hospital to determine whether or not he was competent to stand trial. He's been there for 8 months, which is a very long time. But at least if you're going to be somewhere, that's Butner Federal Hospital is a lot better than other places you could be. In any case, they dropped all his charges today.
Well, I guess that's good news, but he's still sat in prison for 8 months. So, like, what's he going to do? Is there going to be a suit?
Oh, I don't know, but that's a lot less than 25 years.
No doubt.
Yeah, yeah.
And he was not going to win. Yeah, exactly. And
well, wait, if he wasn't going to win, why did they drop the charges?
Well, that's interesting, isn't it? So, you know, I mean, I'm, like, crying because I'm thrilled because I love my brother so much and everything. And, but, you know, I just wish that I could have a different perspective, but I've just been screwed by the state so many times and have seen what they do. But do you know what my first thought was after, oh, my God, Tony, I love you, I can't wait to see you? My second one was, I hope they don't use my brother for one of their events.
What do you mean, their events?
Well, you know how, like, these kids keep turning up after, you know, after they've killed 25 students or something like that, you know, and then they go, oh, well, this person was mentally ill and everything. And as like strange and as paranoid as this sounds, my second thought was really, oh God, they're going to take my, you know, brother who they've determined is suffering from persecutorial complex, but that he is healthy enough to not be forced medication. That was what they said. Healthy enough to be not forced to be medicated, and they're dropping the charges.
So wait, are you're worried that they're going to brainwash him and turn him into like a theater shooter or something? I'm not really sure what you're getting at.
No. More like how passports ended up on top of a heap after 9/11. That were completely intact.
You're saying that they're going to frame him for something that he didn't do?
It's
just a concern she had.
Yes, like, I mean, it's sad the world we live in, and that instead of just being rejoiceful,
you're scared that the other shoe's going to drop, they're going to do something to him. Yeah, I see where you're coming from there, Michele, and I hope you can put it out of your mind and enjoy going to Vegas, because you're going to be there. Are you speaking at the Bitcoin conference, Bitcoin Investor Conference? Are you going to be speaking?
I am going to have the most amazing Bitcoin panel to date. I have a special guest who has not attended a single Bitcoin conference.
Ooh.
And I have actually two special guests who have not ever attended a Bitcoin conference. So that's going to be really exciting.
So you can't say who it is.
Cannot say who it is, but
what kind of panel doesn't announce its panelists in advance, Michele Seven?
A really good one.
The kind of panel where people say, "Don't tell anyone I'm coming."
Okay, interesting. Well, I've got Gavin Andreessen.
So yeah. I've got better.
Gavin Andreessen is the head programmer of Bitcoin. I don't know how you can top that one. So I'm looking forward to hearing this, Mark. You're going to have to let us know.
I'm going to be there with Mark, and we're going to, like, co-host or something or do some kind of thing.
You better really co-host excited. With Mark. He's going to need it.
I will cover him, and hopefully I can get his vein bulging.
The one in his forehead.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah, of course. What did you think I meant?
I don't know, Michele.
You never know with Michele.
All right, well, I wish I could see you there, Michele. Thanks for the call tonight. I really
keep your hopes up, that there are, you know, hopefully we're just going to think that this is just a really great thing and that my brother just happened to win this time, and that sometimes you win. Even with the state. And so for Ross's family and other people, I mean,
I've had a few wins. It can happen. I've had a few wins. I've beaten a speeding ticket. I've beaten an unconstitutional no trespass order in the government courts, and something else. I'm just forgetting what it was. The arrest for recording video. I got a payout on that one. Thanks, Michele. Appreciate hearing from you. And enjoy the Bitcoin Investor Conference this weekend, or actually Thursday and Friday.
This is 25 years reduced to 8 months. And Michele admits that he was going to lose, that he didn't have a case. So I think that she's right to be concerned and try to get to the bottom of this and find out all facts. I mean,
you also think alien ships blasted down the World Trade Center?
When did I say that?
I'm joking.
I was going to say, which kind of aliens?
I'm joking. You haven't said that, but you don't think the U.S. landed on the moon?
Yeah, there's more than one kind of alien, Mark. You've got the ones living amongst us, and you have the
grays. The gray aliens.
You got the reptile underneath
you.
Human
just
skin.
Go ahead and keep talking about the reptilians. I'll make sure your butt gets disappeared.
Hey, I'm all in favor of sending some cameras over to the moon and get some detailed photos of those footprints. I want to see them.
You can join us here. We got plenty of time for you to share your thoughts with us. Maybe if we get a chance, we'll tell you some crazy Venezuela news. But your calls are welcome. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And we also have Skype. You can Skype into the show. You'll sound really good when you're on Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. This is Free Talk Live. Join us here on the radio waves.
I was coming out of the hardware store when I saw him. An old man, late 70s, hunched over in the freezing rain, no hat on his head, limping across that slippery parking lot, and pushing a row of shopping carts toward the cart corral. It's heartbreaking. Millions of hardworking Americans simply don't have enough money to retire, so they just keep working and working and working until it's too late. Hi, I'm Chad Stubbs, President and CEO of PowerTrader, and I believe that's just plain wrong. That's why I'm now distributing to the public absolutely free copies of PowerTrader's game-changing book on how regular folks can make the money they need to retire fast. For your free copy, call 1-800-771-6706. Don't let the lack of money rob you of your retirement. Call now for details and get your free copy of this book before it's too late. 1-800-771-6706. But hurry while supplies last. 1-800-771-6706. 1-800-771-6706.
My name is Bill Bonner, and I'm the president of the largest private news and research network in the world. And I paid for this airtime because I have an important message to the American people. There's a change coming that the government isn't telling you about. This change has deep implications for life in America, from where you shop to the doctors you visit and the family you want to protect. Look, I've made predictions like this before. Thing is, I was right then, too. A few years ago, I warned that housing prices would collapse. They did. Before that, I warned that dot-com companies would crash. They did. Those who listened had a chance to save themselves. But this has nothing to do with the stock market. This will affect us all.
You can watch the video for free right now by going to disappearingwealth.com. Again, that's disappearingwealth.com.
This is a national health care alert from the Health Hotline. If you, a family member, or a loved one suffers from knee pain and have Medicare as your primary insurance, we've got great news. You could qualify for a pain-relieving knee brace at little or no cost to you. Get free delivery, and all the paperwork is handled by our accredited suppliers at no charge to you. So if you're on Medicare and have knee pain, don't wait. You may qualify to immediately receive a pain-relieving knee brace at little or no cost. Friendly agents are are standing by 24/7 to help you. We also have other pain-relieving braces, too, for your shoulder, ankle, or back. You may be eligible to get these items and more at little or no out-of-pocket cost. Our friendly representatives are standing by now to help you, so please call now. 800-301-2963. 800-301-2963. 800-301-2963. 800-301-2963.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the free state, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and of course, you can join us right here. Our toll-free number for you is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype as well. It's Skype username lrn.fm. With you tonight, you've got Ian.
And Conan.
And Mark.
Conan, you host your own show. It is a monthly program that is television program.
That's
also
right.
On
it's
YouTube.
It's a vodcast. You get it video and or audio format. The site is blacksheeprising.org. Mr. Darryl W. Perry just walked in the room.
Presidential candidate.
That's right. A regular co-host. We will be putting on a show at Keenevention Saturday at lunch. We're going to have a couple of guests you guys might be familiar with. One of them is Brett Vinat. He'll be
there for the
second hour.
He's the host of School Sucks Project.
Yeah, I was allocating like 15-minute, 20-minute blocks, and I asked Brett, I'm like, dude, you want to be on sometime in the second hour? He's like, yeah, how long can I be on?
The whole hour.
I'm like, well, hell, you could be on as long as you want.
So, all right, so great.
The whole second hour.
Has he ever been on Black Sheep Rising before?
He's been on one time for sure, maybe two times.
Okay. Because he doesn't live around here, so it's hard to get him.
He moves around. These crazy libertarians, man, they're always moving around, and they just can't seem to put roots down.
Some of them do.
It's the craziest thing. I've got my roots down. I can't stand the move. It's just a pain in the butt.
I've been here for 9 years now in the same place, and I don't even like to leave New Hampshire. I don't like
leaving Keene.
Yeah. Well, I think you're going to get
I have a hard time driving to Walmart, dude.
I think you're going to get more people who are going to put down roots as the Free State Project moves towards completion, because the younger people are the more mobile. They're the ones that are easier, they're more able to just kind of pick up their lives and move somewhere else. Of course, we're talking about the Free State Project, which is the idea of concentrating liberty-minded activists in one geographic area, not just Keene, New Hampshire, but the entirety of New Hampshire is that geographic area. So somebody was complaining on Facebook today about the Free State Project. Why don't we just try this in all 50 states?
Ugh.
It's like, oh my God, are you just completely brand new to doing activism? Would you not rather be in a place where you had 2,000 activists instead of 20 of them? I mean, the numbers make all of the difference.
That's right.
And we do have over 1,500 people who've already made the move here as part of the Free State Project. And there are 17,500 plus that have signed the pledge to make the move. We're going to hit that 20,000 number probably sometime next year. And then the 20,000 people will have a five-year window in which to move. Then you're going to start to see more of the committed people, the people who, all right, I don't know if I want to uproot my entire business. I don't know if I want to sell my home if this thing's not going to work out.
Right.
Right. So they don't want to move in advance. They don't want to be the early movers, but they're going to be in that group of the 20,000. We're still seeing some of those people because it's been a decade now that the Free State Project has been moving, that people have been moving here for the Free State Project. And I think, you know, early on, the least committed people are the ones that come early. And as time goes on, you get the families, you get the business people. I think you're going to see that.
Well, I heard you say that you were frustrated with somebody who's suggesting that we have activism in all 50 states like they do here in New Hampshire. And what I would recommend, like, didn't you think that the very first instant that you heard about the Free State Project?
The first thing I thought of was, wow, I want to be there, but it's cold. I'm not sure if I want to go.
But I mean, I guess what I'm trying to say is that it's a relatively common objection or thought when people first hear about the Free State Project. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this would be a really great idea to do in all 50 states. Why don't we do this in all 50 states? Well, because you can't. You can't concentrate people in one state.
Which makes me feel like that person is just a Facebook libertarian and they've never actually done any real activism, ever actually gone out and met anyone else who's a libertarian in their area. Because
well,
otherwise,
they'd
be.
People are coming to the ideas of liberty all the time. So yeah. They may have just been new, Ian.
No, that's what I said, that they've never done anything. So they don't even understand how, you know, pathetic the Libertarian Party is all around the country because hardly anybody gets active and does anything with it. Let's go to your calls and thoughts here. If you want to learn more about the Free State Project, you can do that at freestateproject.org. And Dave is on the line in Arizona. You're on Free Talk Live. Dave.
Would that be me?
If you're Dave in Arizona.
I'm John in Arizona.
All right. Sorry about that, John in Arizona. Go ahead.
Am I speaking with Ian?
Yes, go for it. You're on with Ian, and then there's also Conan and Mark in the studio.
Conan gets my vote for the voice of reason, the cool head voice of reason in the room.
Thank you, sir. What did I say in particular that got my your approval?
Well, you were discussing the policeman in South Carolina that got in all this grease for the way he conducted himself.
Right.
And you took a cool head approach to it, and you didn't get upset like the other guy, Ian. I think that's his name, right, Ian?
There's three.
Yep,
three people
there's
in the room.
People here. Okay.
Yeah, I mean the main guy. I think it's Ian. I got a suggestion for you, Ian. Before I go on, you know those bitcoins you're talking about?
Yeah.
Yeah. Use a couple of them to get you a body cam that's got 24-hour coverage.
Why would I do that?
Buy yourself a pocket attorney because that police department all over the country is going to be looking for you.
I'm not scared.
He mostly doesn't leave, and the police department here is kind of familiar with him. I mean,
and we all have cameras, so I mean, it's a body camera really isn't necessary. We're always filming these individuals.
You don't think a police department would snuff Ian out, do you?
Oh yeah, I do.
Yeah. Well,
are you scared of the cops, Dave?
I got pictures of him in every bathroom stall in that police department.
In which police department?
The one where you're from.
You think so?
Keene, New Hampshire.
That's kind of creepy. Why would they have my picture in their bathroom stall?
Well, in case they run out of TP.
Oh, that's hilarious.
But hey, no, he's onto something, though. You know that we have gone to the police department, and Garrett has. I know that.
Yeah.
They were expecting him. They're like, oh, we just got finished watching the video you just posted an hour ago. They had already watched it, so I know that they are regularly watching freekeen.com.
Oh, absolutely. They got nothing better to do. I mean, they're either out arresting college students or they're watching our videos. So
there's an immediate opening for a school resource officer in Columbia, South Carolina, in case you're interested in the job.
Thanks, Dave. Thanks for the call tonight. Hilarious. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733.
It sounds like he thinks the police officers are going to snuff people out, which,
some have.
Not high praise.
Let's go to Steve in Indiana, listening to WIBC. That can't be possible. We're not on the radio tonight, right, Steve? Steve in Indiana?
Steve. Yeah, me?
Hi. We're not on the radio tonight, are we?
No, you're not.
Okay, very good. So you're on listening via the internet, I presume. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Yeah. My thoughts are about the whole Nobles Bill thing. The cops giving cop block such a hard time.
The cop blockers were arrested for chalking outside of the Noblesville, Indiana Police Department. Yes, sir. What about it?
Yes, they were. And you know, that kind of bothers me.
What part?
The free speech part.
The fact that they were arrested for chalking bothers you?
Yes.
Me too. It certainly bugs me. Do you live anywhere near Noblesville, Indiana there?
Yeah, I'm about 30 miles from Noblesville.
Well, then what I'd suggest to you, if this bothers you, if you go to freekeen.com, there's a post there. It's also over at copblock.org. That'll actually give you the phone number for the Noblesville Police Department, I believe, or the judge. There are a couple numbers there. And then they suggest that you grab some chalk and go to Noblesville Police Department and join in the fun. Steve, thanks for the call tonight. Go to copblock.org to see the story or freekeen.com. This is Free Talk Live.
You heard the discussions all over the radio. You couldn't believe what you were hearing. You trusted them. How could you have not seen the signs? You felt betrayed. Outrage set in. Your emotions began to consume you. Then, nothing. Now they're talking football. Days turned to weeks and months. Then, you've forgotten. But they haven't. They're still monitoring your every move. It's coming. Monitor blockitpocket.com. Or will you forget?
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists. Get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow. A new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
Keenevention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenevention.info. Keenevention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, illegal Uber driver Christopher David, NeoCash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Silvia, rated an A+ by the NHLA, the Seditious Sirens, the Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, tech guru Brian Sovereign, Cop blocker J.P. Freeman, new mover Dr. Taryn Lupo, longtime political activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallowkeen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenevention.info. Visit keenevention.info for more speaker announcements, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenevention.info.
Are you tired of governments around the world killing innocent people? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin is money that cannot be inflated or controlled by any state. By continuing to use their money, you're perpetuating the killing. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available to you now. Learn it, use it, spread it.
Get started with Bitcoin at Bitcoin.com. It's Bitcoin.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
You can join us here. Toll-free number for you is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Tonight in the studio, you've got Ian.
And Conan.
And Mark.
Conan, you mentioned that your show, Black Sheep Rising, which you can go to blacksheeprising.org, is going to be live at Keenevention coming up this weekend. Keenevention tickets are still available online. Keenevention runs from Friday the 30th through November 1st, which is Sunday. So the entire weekend, we've got a full schedule every day during Keenevention, both from as early as 9:30 in the morning. Actually, one day Yuri's going to come in at 7:50 from Russia. He's not in Russia right now, but moved here.
Yuri, the White Russian.
He moved here from Russia, and he's going to be doing a yoga, seminar or class, or not really a class, but a yoga session, if you will, beforehand. So there's cool things that people do around.
He's having a dance off too during my bonfire.
That's correct. Yeah, he's competing with your bonfire, but he did set it later, so yeah. He's going to actually be at your bonfire, and then he's going to go dancing in Keene, and so folks can join him. Which is kind of one of the cool things I like about Keenevention is that I'm the organizer of Keenevention, but I don't have to actually organize everything, which is cool. Like Conan wants to throw a bonfire. Great, I'll put it on the schedule. Yuri wants to do some yoga. Okay, cool. I'll put that on the schedule too. So like there's these things that kind of self-organize during Keenevention that people can go and do. And I think that's another fun aspect to the event. The main focus of Keenevention is activism, though. It's focusing on the different types of activism that go on here in New Hampshire. Everything from getting active within the legislative, in the political processes, to cop block. We've got cop blocker J.P. Freeman going to be heading up the cop block panel this year. And we've also got all kinds of other discussions. There's going to be 11 total panels happening at Keenevention. We've got three great keynote speakers, including our own Daryl W. Perry, the presidential candidate for the Libertarian Party. Christopher David, the illegal Uber driver. We've talked a lot about Uber here on Free Talk Live. And Chris David is doing amazing work on the seacoast of New Hampshire, making, I think, what should be international headlines. I don't know if he has made international headlines, but he deserves to, as one of the Uber drivers who's basically leading the way of civil disobedience. Even though Uber is prohibited from operating in Portsmouth, New Hampshire, Uber hasn't shut off their system, and he's out there giving people rides illegally.
All the videos against Uber I see coming from Europe, from South America.
You mean from the cabbies?
From the cabbies, the cabbie unions, yeah. Coming out and throwing bricks through Uber drivers' windshields and spitting on them and pulling them out of their driver's seats. But nothing's come from the States yet. But I know, especially if you go to freekeen.com, you can actually read some of the stories that have taken place in the seacoast here in New Hampshire. They don't want this. They
meaning the city council?
The city council does not want Uber. They have created ordinances that will prevent private drivers, because that's basically what it is. You know, private drivers using the Uber software or the setup to make some spare money on the side. Or some of these guys are actually doing it full time, I guess. But it's as far as a part time position, this is great.
Yeah, absolutely. You can do it whenever you want. So you decide when you log in.
You get
as a
off work, and maybe you're just driving through town, and you're someone who just likes to drive around.
So yep.
You just turn it on and say, "Hey, I'm available." It's like turning the light on the top of your cabbie, but you can use your own vehicle. You don't have to rent some crazy expensive cab from the man.
I'm a big fan of Uber generally.
It's great.
And yeah, they have a competitor called Lyft, but I don't think they're operating in New Hampshire. So anyway, the illegal Uber driver, he's going to be our Saturday night keynote speaker. That's Saturday night's like the big night at Keenevention. It's the night of the Halloween costume dance party. You can go and see the full list. Also, Chris Reitman, who we've had guest host Free Talk Live a couple times, he's an oath keeper and he's also a town selectman. He's the guy who helped repeal all gun regulations in the town of Alstead, New Hampshire. I mean, that's one of the things that he's done. I'm sure he'll talk more about what it's been like to be a libertarian and a town selectman at the same time. He's a really, really great guy. So you'll get to meet all these people if you're at Keenevention, and it's not too late to get your tickets online. Go to keenevention.info. If you can get up here to New England, if you're in New England, you can get to New Hampshire and get to Keene this weekend. You don't want to miss Keenevention. It's going to be
and it's not snowing yet, so don't worry about the cold.
No, anything can happen by the weekend, but it's expected to be in the 50s during the daytime, and it should be relatively clear. So go and check it out, keenevention.info. Learn more about the panels. The Bitcoin panel is going to be, I think, pretty epic. And lots of other great panels. Go check it out. Keenevention.info. Get your tickets now. Don't wait till the day of. Let's go to Steve, listening in Utah. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Steve.
Hey, enough of that that free Keen. Now we go back to Vegas. I had a question on the Bitcoin conference in Vegas.
Yeah.
What time is the first item there? I'm not getting much information off the website. When's the first seating for the conference?
Well, I know the doors open. I think it's in the morning at 9 a.m. I don't have to do my show until 4, so I couldn't tell you exactly. I would think you go to bitcoininvestor.com, look at the agenda, and it should tell you right there. It says Thursday, 7:30 to 8:45 is registration. That's in the morning. 9 a.m. is the welcoming remarks.
So it's bitcoininvestor.com to learn more about it. Steve, anything else you want to share?
Well, I had a little bit of sarcasm there. I was going to say the young girl there in South Carolina, was it, that got beat up by the cop?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, she had it coming, you know. She's been convicted to a prison called the school system, and she needs to learn what prisons are really about. And this is really here a good demonstration of what prisons are for.
That's funny, Steve. Thanks for the call, and hopefully you'll make it to the conference, and you'll see Mark. Thanks for the call. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Jay is on the line. Jay in Colorado. Hey, Jay Noon.
Hey, thanks for having me on.
Yes, sir.
Hey, I just wanted to call and let your listeners know in the Denver area that tomorrow afternoon they're having a Republican debate in Boulder. And I've been meeting with the We Are Change Colorado folks every week. And what we're going to do is we're going to have a who is anti-war? Who's against the war? Basically rally or meeting. There's a Facebook page for it. I don't have my tablet with me.
Is this
right
against
now.
A specific war or against war in general?
It's who's against the war in general, basically, because what's going to happen is there's going to be a lot of Democrat, liberal types protesting Republicans, and we want to bring light that there is no Republican or no Democrat that is for peace. No, I'm sorry, that's what it is. Who's for Peace is what it's called.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why I got it wrong here, but Who's for Peace, if you look that up on Facebook, you should be able to find the event that the Bruce Bannerman set up.
And so far you've been able to tell that none of the candidates are have come out and said that they're against the war and for peace?
Well, I'm sorry. No, none of them are for peace based on their voting record and their rhetoric that they've said. I mean, Bernie Sanders and Hillary voted, you know. Well, Bernie, his voting record is, you know, he voted right with Bush and, you know.
Yep.
What about Rand Paul? He's still in favor of some war, huh?
He is. We kind of went through them all last night for a little while, you know, doing a little checking up, making mm-hmm. sure that, you know, we knew what we were talking about. And, yeah, he's there's clips where he says that we'll get out of Iraq, but we'll go in Afghanistan. And so we just want to basically prove, we want to show the liberals that their Hillary and Bernie is really no different than Bush and, you know, any of the other Republicans when it really comes down to it. They're all controlled by the same money, which these listeners know. And that's kind of our goal tomorrow in Boulder.
Cool. Oh, this is in Boulder. Okay, I was thinking Denver for some reason. Okay, so Boulder.
Yep.
And We Are Change. They're a pretty big organization, right? How many people are involved in that where you are?
Well, We Are Change Colorado. Adam Kokesh was there 3 weeks ago, and about 35 people showed up to that particular meeting.
Not bad.
And there's been about 10, 15 people showing up at the Monday night meetings we've been doing at the Denver Bitcoin Center.
Sounds about like your typical libertarian group, about 10, 15, maybe swinging up toward 30 on a big event. Got to get those guys to New Hampshire.
Like
Are you telling
Hampshire.
Them about moving to New Hampshire, Jay Noon?
I'm telling them all about the Free State Project in New
awesome.
Hampshire every time.
Look forward to seeing you back here. Thanks for the call tonight, man. Good luck with the protest or the outreach. I appreciate hearing from you. It's great to hear people doing stuff, no doubt about it. 855-450-FREE allows you to join us here in the remaining moments of Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. The new fourth edition of Healing Our World, The Compassion of Libertarianism, will take your understanding of liberty to a deeper level and has over 1,300 updated references, new cartoons, and a foreword by Dr. Ron Paul. With discounts for multiple book purchases, the fourth edition of Healing Our World is a great gift for the liberals, pragmatists, environmentalists, and Christians in your life who think libertarianism is cold-hearted. Get yours today at healing.freetalklive.com and use promo code FTL for a $5 discount.
You can control your health care with Liberty Health Share.
Liberty Health Share is like-minded people coming together to share medical costs, which saves money.
You don't even have to pay for procedures that violate your conscience.
Because we all share the same values.
Join the movement of people who share in medical costs and change the way you pay for your health care forever.
Go to libertyhealthshare.org to find out more.
Liberty Health Share.
Together, we're changing health care for good. libertyhealthshare.org.
So you've got to take a state construction license exam or certification. Can't decide on what books or what chapters to study? Discover right now how you can eliminate unnecessary books and wasted study time. At contractorexam.com, our study materials zero in on state-required test topics in an effective, multiple-choice format. So whether you're a plumber, electrician, general contractor, or other construction-related trade, contractorexam.com will help get you prepared. Visit us at www.contractorexam.com today.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral! Don't take on the IRS alone! I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill sometimes! I can even get it zeroed out completely!
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral!
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on to join the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is Free Talk Live. Moments remain. Got enough time for you if you want to join us here. 855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number. 855-450-3733. We've got our brand new website online at freetalklive.com. Please go check it out if you haven't been in a while. I hope you like the changes. We actually added a blog feature to it. We're going to start doing, Mark, you're going to do more blogging once you get back from your trip to Vegas. But there are some initial blogs that you've posted up there. You can see that by going to freetalklive.com and then clicking FTL News. It's real big right next to the show topics section where you can still submit and suggest show topics to us as well. So it's a very interactive site. You can go to freetalklive.com. If you like what we're doing here on Free Talk Live, talking about liberty on a regular basis, we're here 7 nights a week on over 150 radio stations. If you'd like us to be on 300 radio stations, if you'd like the ideas of liberty to be spread around the globe via satellite, online, to more people, then you can help us for $5 a month with the Free Talk Live AMP program. AMP stands for Advertise, Market, and Promote. The money is used to invest into Free Talk Live so we can spread the message of liberty around the world. If that's worth $5 a month to you, like the price of a fancy cup of coffee, we sure would appreciate your support. Please go to amp.freetalklive.com. You can get signed up there with any major credit card through PayPal. Also, we've got a Visa and MasterCard right on our website. And plus, there's going to be a brand new way to AMP Free Talk Live coming, I hope, by the end of this weekend. It's already kind of been implemented. You might see it if you go to the site, but I don't know if it's working yet. So to some extent, if you try the new method, if you go to amp.freetalklive.com and try that, it may or may not work for you. But once it is working for sure, I'll let you know. Go to amp.freetalklive.com and please get behind the show. We really appreciate it. It's Ian, Conan, and Mark in the studio. We go to your calls and thoughts. Dan is on the line in Pennsylvania, listening via TuneIn. Hello, Dan.
Hey, how's it going?
Hey, great. Go ahead, sir.
Yeah, so I called about almost exactly a month ago and talked about a speeding ticket that I got where the cop kind of miscalculated it, and he wrote down 51 for my speed, but he also wrote the time and the distance, and the math worked out to 41.
That's right. Okay.
Yeah, so I had my trial this morning, actually, so I figured I would share how it went.
Great. Were you able to record the trial?
I did not. I had a friend who was willing to, but he ended up having to work, so it didn't actually work out. I really wanted to.
Bummer.
Yeah.
All right. Tell us more.
Yeah, so I have to say it was my first time, and I didn't do nearly as good as I should have. I learned a whole lot, but I did end up getting kind of lucky, and I did end up with a not guilty verdict.
Whoa!
So, yeah. So
how?
That was pretty nice.
Normally, they got you by the balls if you're in a speeding ticket trial, because you know they believe the cop. The cop can say whatever he wants, and you know you get convicted. How did you get a not guilty?
Right. So I started with. I showed him the math. I said, look, you clocked me this distance and this time. The math says that I was going 41, not 51. And honestly, I thought that should be enough. I mean, because if that's the case, then the ticket conflicts with itself. The officer is conflicting with himself. I was able to get him to read those numbers to me. Mm-hmm. And before I showed him the mistake, he said, yeah, I'm completely sure this is what happened. There's no reason for anything to be wrong, anything like that. So that all went well enough. And I kind of made my case like, hey, this doesn't make any sense. So that was kind of my closing argument. But then, right before, at some point during my questioning, I said, do you have the certification ticket for the equipment? Because it has to be certified within 60 days. And he said, yeah, I've got it right here. Mm. And he started flipping through his papers to show it to me. And I said, oh, no, I believe you. You got it. And that was a mistake. Well, I mean, like I said, I got lucky, which I'll explain in just a second.
Okay.
But for anyone who's going to trial, make sure you look over every bit of evidence that you can.
Right.
So anyway, as it turned out, I'm trying to be quick here. I know we're close. As it turned out, like 10 minutes later, after I asked him for it and I said, oh, I believe you have it. He eventually found it and he just handed it to me. He's like, oh yeah, here I have it. If you want to look at it, this was right before the judge was about to rule. And so I'm like, oh yeah, I'll look over it. I checked the serial number and it matched up. But then I checked the date on the certification and the date was actually after the ticket was issued. And so the judge said, well, this math stuff that you showed us did not save your butt. but that certification did. I'm going to rule not guilty.
Yep. Once he found out he was going to have to take, he was going to court. He says, "Yo, I better get all my I's dotted and T's crossed and certification.
Done.
Yeah, certs need to get done."
Wow. Yeah, nice job, man. Officer, congratulations.
Yeah, thanks. I have one question. The officer said, as soon as I pointed it out, he said, "Oh, that's my fault. I just grabbed the wrong paper." And, you know, the judge didn't really count that. But as I was walking out, the officer said, "I need to go make a road trip and get the right piece of paper." And that made me wonder, I think this has to be impossible because of double jeopardy, but is there a chance that he's getting the right paper in order to show the judge and try to get a new trial?
No, it's too late. Game over. You win.
That's awesome. All right.
If you consider winning, you know, having to spend hours of your time dealing with the court system.
This is actually...
That's another thing. It was a super small town. It was just me, the cop, the judge, and the clerk. Yeah. I was in and out in 25 minutes.
Huh.
So,
well, that was nice.
Hey,
cool. What were you going to add, Conan? Add something there?
Go ahead. Go ahead, caller.
Just real quick for anyone listening, the two biggest things I learned are I felt like I had made my point, and so I didn't end up hitting all the notes that I had in my closing argument. Yep. I'm like, I showed him the mistake. I should be good. So if anyone goes to trial, argue every single point that you can think of, even if you think you've made your point.
Yep.
Go through everything.
You always want to do that, too,
argument.
In case you end up appealing. You can't bring up an appeal on an issue that you didn't actually mention or talk about or ask about during the trial. That's not legal advice, but it's just my experience. Hey, thanks, Dan, and congratulations on your experience. And this is true about this is what we've said on the show, is that you can go to trial for this little stuff as long as there's no ridiculous court fees where you live. Because there are in some places. You go to the trial for this little stuff like a speeding ticket or a parking ticket, it's a great learning opportunity to actually experience what it's like to be in court, to feel that, you know, to get past the adrenaline of being up there and in front of people or whatever. I guess in his case, there really wasn't anyone there to watch.
Still, there's a great deal of adrenaline.
Oh, yeah.
Right. And in that case, the adrenaline is being alone in a room with a bunch of bureaucrats who could hurt you in that particular case. But yeah, that's great. And I highly recommend this. Only thing I recommend, though, is move to New Hampshire and do it here, where you can actually have activists come back you up in court. You want somebody to come record the trial? Just ask. You'll probably find somebody who's willing to step up and do that. So let's continue here. We've got Steve, someone else on the line here about a speeding ticket. Steve, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, yes.
Hey, you got to turn that down in the background, man. It's going to drive people crazy. It's going to drive you crazy. Hearing that.
It's going to drive me crazy, you guys crazy. Hold on, let me turn it down.
Yeah, I appreciate that. Rule number one when you're on hold for a talk radio is turn off the radio.
You guys would get me so quick.
All right, here you are.
Okay, here I am. So anytime you get a speeding ticket, it is very important not just to pay the speeding ticket. If you go to court and the cop does not show up, then you can get out of that speeding ticket just
it's
by
true.
The fact.
I've done it that way once.
And I have beat several tickets like that.
You're right, Steve. Thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. It's worked for me on one occasion. And, you know, you don't know if the cop's going to show up or not. If you go ahead and pay the ticket, then you're done. But if you say not guilty and you schedule the trial, then you have a chance at winning.
I've heard a cop say that he loved it when people took their tickets to trial because
he gets paid extra.
He gets time and a half for showing up to court.
Both callers mentioned what I think got me out of my last speeding ticket, and that was double jeopardy and the cop not showing up the second time around. Yeah, so let me just explain what happened. I didn't get some information from the other side, and once
meaning you didn't get discovery.
I didn't get discovery. Okay. So once the cop was up there testifying against me, I made claim. I said, "Hey, look, I didn't get any of this information," and they went ahead and retrialed.
Was I in the courtroom for this? I don't remember.
I think you were there, and I said, I was like, "What about double jeopardy?" And I think just saying that. Prevented the cop from showing up a month or 2 months later.
Huh.
I'm not sure. He didn't show up the second time, so it was thrown out.
Sometimes you never know because you can't really compare apples to apples usually when it comes to court because you know, if they go one direction, you don't know what it would have been if they'd done things a different way.
Mm-hmm.
But the more we try things, the more different approaches that we can make in the courtrooms, the more people can learn from it. A lot of people watch the videos that we make here in Keene of courtroom experiences because video like what we make here in Keene doesn't exist anywhere else.
Yeah, you're not allowed to take them cameras in a lot of other courtrooms around the country.
At least you can see our mistakes.
Yeah, absolutely, and hopefully learn from them. All right, so go to Conan's website, blacksheeprising.org. They'll be live at Keenevention this weekend on Saturday, and don't miss Keenevention, keenevention.info. Mark heads to Vegas. We'll see you tomorrow night.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. I know this sounds unbelievable, but at my house, we saved as much as 45% off of a new item on Amazon. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. It's saveatpurse.com.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Rebel Love Show is next, live after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, October 27th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.88 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,166 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $292. Antiwar.com reports Kurdish forces for the People's Protection Units, YPG, and the Free Syrian Army forces who were fighting alongside them reported they came repeatedly under fire from Turkish soldiers across the border into Tel Abyan, a town the Kurds recently seized from the Islamic State and absorbed into the Kobani Canton. According to the forces on the ground, they repeatedly came under brief machine gun fire from the Turkish side of the border, but did not return fire on the Turkish soldiers. Turkey has not directly addressed this report, but did hint at their involvement. Turkish President Erdogan blasted the YPG for its recent gains in his comments.